Republican House members at a meeting on Friday morning with the announcement that he would resign his seat effective October 30th. U.S. Representative Kevin McCarthy of California, the number two House Republican, quickly became the leading contender to replace Boehner as Speaker. While loyal to Boehner, McCarthy has built personal relationships with conservative groups and tacked right recently to back the shutdown of the Export-Import Bank. Boehner has faced constant pressure from conservatives who believe he was too willing to compromise with President Obama and too frequently relied on Democratic votes to pass crucial legislation. Boehner told reporters he was stepping aside to avoid another brewing House battle over his leadership. Conservatives had threatened a revolt and possible government shutdown over spending next week. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
Jack Daniel's announced today its plan to start marketing directly to children, adding, quote, why not? Executives for the whiskey company told reporters that they've already slated dozens of television spots showing 10-year-old children drinking tumblers of Jack and Coke in playgrounds, and that the company was planning on, quote, just seeing how it all played out.
Every year, Jack Daniel's sells millions of dollars of great American whiskey to men and women all over the world. So for our next ad campaign, we basically just thought, hey, why not just start marketing this stuff straight to 10-year-olds? I mean, if they catch us, they catch us, but we'll see how far it goes, and hopefully we can sell some alcohol along the way. Sure, some parents' groups could get upset, especially if we go with our idea of moms serving their kids cranberry jack at snack time. But
in other news, a doomed rabbit will teach an 8-year-old a lesson about responsibility, and a torrent of soap issues from a wildly unexpected part of the dispenser. Well, that was it. It's all downhill from here, bud. For more, visit theonion.com.
This is the Onion News Network.
Free Talk Live.
It's Free Talk Live, and you can join us here. We'll give you the toll-free numbers and Skype in moments. We're here live on this live Saturday edition of the program. With you tonight, you've got me, Ian.
And me, Mark.
And you can join us online. Just go and get interactive at freetalklive.com. Unlike those other talk show websites, ours is totally free. So go and enjoy. Another guy who put up a website for people to use for free is a man named Kim.com. Yes, that's his name. I suspect he was not born with the name last name .com.
I suspect not.
And it is spelled out D-O-T-C-O-M, Kim.com. He is in court in New Zealand in an extradition hearing where the United States would like him to face trial for all manner of supposedly dastardly crimes, including copyright infringement, racketeering, and money laundering. So they're trying to paint Kim.com as some sort of evil man. And maybe he even said something like that about himself. There's some interesting story. It's an interesting story here from Nick Perry at the Associated Press. Prosecutors say Kim.com and his colleagues sometimes reveled in their role as, quote, modern-day pirates, unquote, discussed how to thwart the justice system, and joked that a judge would one day realize how, quote, evil, unquote, they were. The much-delayed extradition hearing for .com and three others who owned or helped run the website Mega Upload began in Auckland this week in a case that could have broader implications for internet copyright rules. Mega Upload was shut down by U.S. authorities in early 2012, but not before prosecutors claimed that it raked in some $175 million, mainly from people who flocked to the site to illegally download movies. Now, the site would allow people to, I believe, pay for a subscription. If I'm recalling Mega Upload correctly, it was one of a myriad of upload anything here sites where you could, without any kind of real necessary ID check or whatever, you could just open up an account and throw up a file on Mega Upload and then give that link to people to download. And that file could be anything. And if it was a, let's say, a compressed file or a zipped file that, you know, that didn't say Katy Perry's new album on it, right? You know, something else. It was Katy Perry's album zipped into a file name that was something completely different.
Right. Baby pictures.
Yeah. It would make it a little more difficult for Mega Upload to just audit their own file system and say, oh, this is, you know, copyrighted, because it was, if it's, you know, compressed and passworded, then only the people who are downloading it would know the password. So there absolutely was There were a lot of files on Mega Upload that were illegal, meaning movies and music and
programs. How did they make their money? If just you had to pay for a subscription to be able to use it sort of on a regular basis, but I mean, I know that many of these services have a free component. They call it freemium is the model. They give away some of their services free, and then there's an upgraded service that you pay for.
Yeah, well, they must have been making their money on the upgraded services, right? So what?
Or advertising.
So one of the, well, yes, advertising as well. They were an incredibly popular site. The story here claims they had 4% of all internet traffic at their peak.
Yes,
so
it's a lot of damn traffic.
So that's a lot of traffic. That's a lot of eyeballs. It would be relatively easy to sell advertisements on a site like that. And in order to upload files above a certain size, you would probably have to become a member. So if you wanted to put up like a full DVD or something like that, maybe it would be easier if you were a paid member. You could probably do it if you broke it into chunks otherwise. But I don't remember what all the features were that you would get as a paid member. I never paid for Mega Upload. I don't know how much I ever uploaded to it, but I've certainly used it to download things. And a lot of things on Mega Upload were completely legal. And naturally, that's going to be one of Kim.com's arguments is that, look, we're just providing this service. This is a blind service. We don't know what you're uploading to our site, and we don't care. It's none of our business. And in fact, he relaunched his site. I don't
know if you knew extent, that. This is how knife and gun manufacturers are, right? You buy a kitchen knife, and you could cut your steak with it, or you could stab a loved one.
Exactly. And so whether that will that argument will fly as far as preventing him from being extradited to the U.S. to face trial, and further will help protect him from the aggression of the U.S. prosecutors still remains to be seen. But to his credit, he did relaunch his site not long after it was taken down and he got out of the handcuffs. He kicked off Mega, so he previously had Mega Upload. Now he has Mega, which is, I believe, Mega.nz. Yeah, that looks like it. And the new Mega.nz has even more security functions on it. And I don't know exactly what makes it different, but I think that the security is to the point where like they can't even know anything about the files at all that you're uploading anymore due to some extra level of encryption. I'm just glossing over.
Right. At this point, they can't be blamed for anything because it's just encrypted uploads.
Yeah, they've and like the encryption's done within your browser, so they don't even hold the keys or something like that.
Yeah.
I think. So they hardened their operation security even further after having their first website taken by the authorities. So ultimately, the government stealing Mega Upload didn't do anything to stop them. I mean, this guy's still out there doing exactly what he's always done, which is providing service to people who want to upload and download things from the internet. And I don't know if you've ever noticed, but emails, you can only usually generally use that for like 10 or 15 or 20 megabytes, which is not a very large amount.
If I want to send something through email, as a matter of fact, I send audio commercials.
Yeah.
I find that I can send a 30-second WAV file, but I can't send a 60-second WAV file.
Yeah.
So this is what the problem I imagine people have is if you have a 3-minute song, you can't email it to people.
So and that's not efficient anyway because the email system isn't designed for mass distribution of files. If you want to send a file to a lot of people, it makes more sense to put it on a server somewhere and give them a link rather than pushing it through a bunch of email servers all around the globe. So .com is facing this extradition hearing, and it is a much delayed one and for he and the three others. Mega Upload was shut down. They raked in $175 million before they got shut down. And .com has been listening to the arguments while slowly swiveling in his black leather armchair, a concession by the judge to his bad back. He is a fairly large man. And according to the story here, parked outside the court is a remnant from the highrollinglifestyle.com long embraced, a black Mercedes SUV with a vanity plate Kim.com. Federal authorities have charged .com and others with the conspiracy to commit copyright infringement, racketeering, and money laundering. A summary of the U.S. case is being presented by New Zealand attorneys as the U.S. attempts to extradite the men to face trial in Virginia. Lawyer Christine Gordon told a judge this week that after .com launched Mega Upload in 2005, the site grew so popular that each day 50 million people used the site, sucking up 4% of all internet traffic.
Epic.
She said this was a big fraud, but conducted in a fairly simple manner. Behind the scenes, she claims, the respondents admitted their business broke the law. Sometimes they enjoyed the fact they were making their money by breaking the law. Sometimes they worried about protection and pondered what action they should take to, and I'm quoting here Mr.com's words, quote, counter the justice system, unquote. Sounds like a man after my own heart.
Well, to some extent, this guy's, I mean, you know, yes, he doesn't agree with copyright and patent as they exist. And, you know,
neither do I.
Well, I don't agree with them as they exist either. There are very few people that do. The only people that seem to like the way it exists today are companies that make their living off of simply owning patents and copyrights.
Record industry people, Motion Picture Industry Association.
And patent trolls.
Yeah. And the government. Yeah. They profit too.
Yeah. Well, how's the government profit?
They get fees.
Oh, fees.
Attorneys. Attorneys really profit from it.
Yeah, the attorneys aren't the government, though.
Yeah, but they are. They get elected, so they pass laws that make business for other attorneys.
The government is a lawyer industrial complex, but the lawyers who are making money off of this aren't the lawyers that are passing the laws necessarily. It's just that lawyers do what lawyers do, and lawyers like laws. So lawyers pass more laws to make it more complicated, so the rest of us can't be. It takes you 600 years to read all the laws in the United States and forget the ones in New Zealand. So
that some people use the site for illegally downloading movies is not in dispute. The real question is the extent to which .com and the others knew about this activity and whether or not they encouraged it. Prosecutors are trying to use the men's own words against them after some of their online chatter was intercepted by the FBI.
That ain't going to be good for them.
Yeah, and there's some interesting quotes coming up here. We'll share those with you. 855-450-FREE. And it should be a heads up for anybody using services on the internet to communicate with your business partners or your friends. You should be aware that, you know, if you're using Skype, for instance, that somebody could be listening. And if you want to call in on Skype, our Skype username is lrn.fm. But you know people are listening when you call us on Skype because it's the radio. It's Free Talk Live. We're coming up.
Understanding your credit score is the first step towards managing and improving it. This is Charlie Sundstrom with your Van Dyke Mortgage Minute. The most influential component of your credit score is your payment history. Almost equally as important is the amount you owe on credit accounts. Also impacting your score, but to a lesser degree, are the length of time you've utilized your credit, the number of new accounts, credit inquiries, and your various types of credit accounts. To help achieve or maintain a healthy credit score, have a system set up to assure your bills are always paid on time. Don't max out your cards. It's better to have a high credit limit with a low balance. Never close old accounts. The age of these can actually help your credit score. But don't be afraid to use your credit. You need several accounts in order to have a credit score. Just keep the corresponding payments within your means. For your mortgage pre-approval and refi needs, start by visiting VanDykeMortgage.com.
Corporate NMLS 3035. Van Dyke Mortgage is an equal housing lender. Charlie Sundstrom, NMLS 134251.
No! That's the sound your brain makes when you realize you're buying something and forgot the coupon. Online or in a store, knowing that you're missing a deal is the worst. You need the app from RetailMeNot right now. Get thousands of coupons from 50,000 stores like Kohl's, Domino's, Best Buy, and more with crazy deals like 60% off, free shipping, and free gifts with purchase. You can get a text invite to download the RetailMeNot app 100% free right now for Apple or Android. Just text the code UPDATE to 42767. Then just show your phone at checkout to save. It literally couldn't be easier. It's 2015. Keep your coupons in your phone. Stop what you're doing and text UPDATE to 42767. Listeners will get a text with a link to download it 100% free. Never forget another coupon again. Text the code UPDATE to 42767 right now. That's UPDATE to 42767.
Message and data rates may apply. For terms and privacy, visit RetailMeNot.com.
So the protection of life, liberty, and property is what the Free State Project is all about. But it's an effort to move 20,000 people who understand.
It's about demonstrating to the entire country
that, yeah, we can have a free market, a truly free market.
Making it just a freer, great place to live.
It's the world's largest voluntarist libertarian community, and it's only getting bigger.
That's amazing, to be able to move to a place where other people like passionately believe in being free and independent.
What the Free State Project is managing to do, though, is to put their money where their mouth is. Physically getting up across the country and saying, let's go someplace and let's demonstrate the power of these ideas. There's a lot of kind of philosophy that surrounds liberty. There's a lot of thinking about it and talking about it. But here in New Hampshire, people are doing it.
101 Reasons Liberty Lives in New Hampshire, a documentary by Free State Project Early Movers. Watch it free at 101reasonsfilm.com. 101reasonsfilm.com.
LRN.fm is proud to announce our official listening apps for Android and iOS devices. Now you can easily tune into our streams anywhere, anytime on your smartphone or tablet. Just visit apps.lrn.fm or search for LRN.fm in the Android or Apple app stores. Please download, rate it 5 stars, then share the link on social media, and let your friends and family know how you're listening to LRN.fm. Download it now, free at apps.lrn.fm. That's apps.lrn.fm.
If you want to move to the free state and you're looking for some real estate.
Oof, I think we've all had enough of that jingle, don't you? If you're going to invest in property in New Hampshire, it just makes sense to support a liberty-friendly realtor. Call Mark Warden of Team Porcupine Real Estate for investment property or rentals in the free state, or visit his website. Come on, you know it.
PorcupineRealEstate.com.
Listen to LRN.FM on any phone, anytime. 213-493-0309. That's 213-493-0309.
It's Free Talk Live, the live Saturday edition of the program. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. And if you're somebody who wants to see Kim.com prosecuted, as well as the other people behind the website Mega Upload who were arrested and charged. Well, I guess they weren't arrested. They were raided, I think it was, a couple of years ago in New Zealand. He is currently still in New Zealand, and they're now, the United States government is trying to extradite him to face charges of conspiracy, which is one of their favorite charges to throw at people. When they don't actually have evidence you did anything, they have to charge you with conspiring to do things. Conspiracy to commit copyright infringement, racketeering, and money laundering. That is their claim, and they're trying to present the evidence in court to get him extradited, as well as his associates, who are also charged, or hopefully, according to the U.S. government, being charged. I hope they are not extradited, and I hope they don't face these charges, because I don't think they did anything that was wrong. They ran a website that allows you, that allowed you, there's a new site called Mega, to replace Mega Upload, but the site allowed you to upload whatever you wanted and then give that link to download to whoever you wanted to give it to. And they didn't really police it, from what I understand. It's like, hey, whatever you upload is your business. It's not ours.
Well, they also sort of knew what was going on.
Of course. And I'm sure they know the same things are going on their new website, Mega.nz, which they've rebranded as the Privacy Company.
And what is going on exactly for people to...
So I did pull up their website, Mark, and since I was sort of speculating about the encryption in the last segment based on my memory, and I was pretty much right, here's their website. It claims they have end-to-end encryption. Unlike with other cloud storage providers, your data is encrypted and decrypted during transfer by your client devices only, and never by us. So that means that they don't even, they don't have access to your files. They can't decrypt them on their own servers. You are basically given the key, essentially, when you upload it to their servers,
yeah.
And then you can give people access to your files.
So you can give move files back and forth with different people. And these are, in many cases, files like movies and songs?
I don't know. They don't know. Mega has no idea what is taking up the... you could get 50 gigs. Okay, so if you want 50 gigs, you start with that for free. And then if you upgrade to their monthly plan, then you get up to 4 terabytes of storage, which is a huge amount of storage.
Yeah, that's a lot.
That's a lot of space. And they're out there, they're doing this, and they couldn't possibly look now. I mean, in the old days, they could at the very least look at their file system, and they could see what the names of the files were. They don't even know that now.
Okay.
So they're even more clueless now than they've ever been about this. But, of course, the new site isn't going to save them from prosecution by the United States for the old site. And so U.S. prosecutors are presenting their case in their own words, using some of the words of .com, his name Kim.com with his associates. They, I guess they snooped in over Skype conversations and others here. The story here from the Associated Press says that sometimes they joked about being pirates or how their site wasn't totally legit or how they weren't the dumb pipe that we claimed to be. And I guess by pipe, they mean like the internet pipes or whatever. They're
I assume what they mean
files.
Is they're a conduit
right.
for people to move information from one place to another.
Right. So sometimes Gordon said, and Gordon is the attorney who's prosecuting in this case, they joked about being pirates. She said that in his native German,
if people are calling you a pirate, it's not unlikely that you're going to be going every once in a while, right? if you keep calling somebody a pirate, they're going to start being silly about it.
Pirates, while generally they were not good people in real life, right? Pirates were brigands and criminals, and they were...
A lot of times they worked for the government.
Yeah. But there is, at least in popular culture, pirates have a very different perspective. You know, people have a different perspective on pirates.
Yeah,
because
Johnny Depp's cool.
Like Johnny Depp and other movies, you know, Pirates of the Caribbean, etc. So, yeah. Anyway, here in 2010.com allegedly said in a Skype conversation with one of his colleagues, quote, "At some point, a judge will be convinced about how evil we are," unquote. Now, does that mean that Kim.com thinks he's evil?
I don't know. I don't know what the context of the conversation.
Yeah, well, that's right. And of course, the U.S. government in this particular portion of the case is not giving the context of the conversation. They're just giving little clips. The defense, by the way, has yet to present its case, but .com has long argued that plenty of people have used his site legitimately to store files, and he can't be held responsible for those who elected to use it for illegal purposes. His lawyers.
There's arguments have been made like this. They don't generally go well for the business in question.
It didn't work for the Silk Road with Ross Ulbricht. Of course, he actually
did
sell mushrooms.
They don't have any business going and trying to drag somebody off from New Zealand either.
His lawyers say any action against him should have been taken in civil court and that criminal charges are unjustified. The professor James Grimmelman, who specializes in internet law at the University of Maryland, said the outcome of the case could have important implications in defining the bounds of U.S. copyright law. He likened it to other cases which are testing the internet's jurisdictional boundaries, such as the European notion of the right to be forgotten. Now, for those that don't know, the right to be forgotten, you recall that case, Mark, with Google?
Yeah, this is in Europe. The situation is essentially that, in Europe, somebody said that, I don't like the things of that are on the internet about me. And what some court decided in...
It was like the International Court in Europe or something.
Some big court in Europe, basically, that, oh, yeah, that's true. You shouldn't be able to... You shouldn't have things that you don't like about you on the internet. So, Google, you have to not reference. Not that you have to remove things from the internet, because Google
can't do that.
But they just tell Google, not any other company, just Google. There's plenty of search engines out there. You can't sort of reference things that people don't want referenced about themselves. So then you've got a whole bunch of people who are like, I don't like my baby pictures. I don't want them up there. Or whatever nonsense it is that they're complaining about and sending off to Google. Google has to open a whole new department to deal with, I don't know, crazy people that don't want their crap on the internet that allowed to go there in the first place. And just nonsense. So Google's they're actually fighting back against it, but we'll see how that goes.
The internet law professor says if .com loses this case, it'll make sites like YouTube pay closer attention to ensure they're being vigilant enough in removing copyrighted material. He added that the U.S. courts would likely be careful to define what distinguishes a pirate site from one that is legitimate. In New Zealand, the extradition hearing has been delayed 9 times since .com was arrested in early 2012 after a dramatic SWAT-style raid on his mansion near Auckland. He was released from jail a month later. And
which SWAT? Is this New Zealand SWAT?
Yeah, I think so.
Then why isn't New Zealand worried about this? This is what I understand. Why does the United States have to charge him criminally from Virginia and go all the way across the globe? This is my point, is that the United States isn't a government in its traditional sense. It is the one world government that people talk about. That watch out for the one world government. We have
one. Is.
It's in Washington, D.C. And it believes that it can stretch its tentacles across the globe. There is no business. If New Zealand has signed on to whatever international agreement there is to respect property rights or intellectual property or whatever it might be, Kim.com can be handled by New Zealand unless you're a control freak in Washington, D.C., and you want to get credit for it and you want to get a notch in your belt so you can move higher up the little ladder.
That's what they
then
did.
You might go beyond your national borders and act like a super nation.
That's what they
did. And act like an imperialist power.
With Mark the seed guy, the Mark Emery from Canada, the Prince of Pot. They extradited him from Canada to face criminal charges in the United States for selling seeds.
It's just, it shows how weak New Zealand and Canada are in dealing with the U.S.
Well, it hasn't happened yet in New Zealand. There's the hearing that's happening right now. 855-450-FREE.
Global warming covertly describes the effects of iron poisoning. CO2 is iron poison blood types and is the body's defense mechanism to buffer the oxygen iron attracts. CO2 in blood and blood type prevalences are used as false evidence for global warming and is the setup for the greatest fraud in history. The healthy blood type AB is on the Shroud of Turin and is their DNA proof they are his Christ. For further information, unveilingthem.com. UNVEILINGthem.com.
Are your Google search results killing you? Unflattering content in blogs, news articles, online reviews, social media, or other sources can jeopardize your reputation, your business, and your livelihood. Let Reputation.com help. Our patented technology will make the truth about you more visible while pushing down unwanted negative content. Improve your Google search results. Call Reputation.com at 1-800-831-0771 for a free consultation. That's 800-831-0771.
Negotiation isn't just something union leaders and sports agents do. Your entire day is a series of negotiations. If you have young children, you know that. In fact, your kids can teach you a lot about negotiating with grown-ups. According to the world's greatest negotiator, Herb Cohen, author of You Can Negotiate Anything. Herb says that kids understand the process of decision-making within an organization. When one parent says no, they'll ask the other. And Cohen says children persist and persevere. And like smart negotiators of all ages, kids know that no is an opening bargaining position. With money and attention so scarce now, effective communication skills have never been more important, especially if you're a job seeker. For more tips, hit survivalspeech.com. I'm Holland Cook.
Are you tired of governments murdering people around the world? Stop using their money. There is an alternative. Bitcoin is a stateless, free market, non-political currency. Bitcoin cannot be inflated or controlled by any government. By using their money, you are helping the state. Stop doing it. You have an incredible alternative available now. Learn it, use it, spread it. Get started with Bitcoin at Bitcoin.com. That's Bitcoin.com.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used and more. It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com.
Free Talk Live.
The result from the drug use, you cannot compare to caffeine or cigarettes. That's an immature...
Right, it's... No, the result of the war on drugs, I can't compare.
The illegal use of drugs. Why don't we execute sellers?
Why don't we execute cigarette smokers?
Then we will no longer have to worry about people using drugs.
Well, all right, there are more than 100,000 people convicted of drugs every year. Do you want to execute all them too?
Okay. Wow.
Look how much money we'd save. $30,000 a year times 100,000. Okay. You know, if we took the Singapore or the Middle East model,
then we'd have a state like Singapore or the Middle East.
President, maybe he can do that.
Singapore and the Middle East have no drugs whatsoever in their countries, right?
Free Talk Live, 7 nights a week from 7 to 10 Eastern, live on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM. If you enjoy LRN.FM, please contribute to your favorite shows via their websites and become an amplifier at amp.lrn.fm. That's amp.lrn.fm.
It's Free Talk Live. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. And maybe you think Kim.com and his associates from Mega Upload should go to prison if you agree with the United States federal government and their demands to prosecute these people for basically just running a website where you can upload stuff know, they didn't care what you uploaded. It's none of their business. They're, you upload files, you they'll allow you to send the link out to people to download them. And they're still doing that business. They've just refined it. They've changed the name. They've got a shorter name now. It's mega.nz is their new site. We're not, by the way, you know, sponsored by Mega, although it'd be great to be sponsored by Mega. I'd be fine with that. You can use the service to store whatever you want. Doesn't have to be illegal, but some people have used it for, you know, copyrighted music and movies and things like that. And that's why the federal government is coming at him. They even did a dramatic SWAT-style raid on his mansion in New Zealand back in 2012. He was released from jail a month later and has attracted intense media coverage ever since. I remember we talked about that when it happened. I had never heard of Kim.com prior to the raid. I had heard of a Mega Upload. And so now his profile arguably has been raised as a result of the U.S. government targeting him.
They're doing some business for him.
Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Privacy does matter here on the internet. And if you care about privacy, you really need to look into ProXPN. They don't keep logs of your activities whatsoever. And ProXPN has more servers than ever before, providing you with a virtual private network that actually encrypts your online data before it reaches your internet service provider. So if you're encrypted, then your ISP, they won't know if you're going to Mega's new website and using that site. Your ISP won't know anything about what you're doing once you start using ProXPN. And they've got software, by the way, for Windows, Mac, iOS, Android, and there's even Linux support as well. You can get 50% off the regular monthly price for the lifetime of the account when you buy their annual account with code FTL50. And there's now an even better deal. If you thought 50% off was pretty good, and that's a pretty good deal, there's now an even better deal. $49.95 gets you 2 years of ProXPN when you pay with Bitcoin. So $49.95 worth of Bitcoin. Here's how you get the deal.
2 years.
2 years.
That's cheap.
That breaks the price down to like half of the previous best price that we'd given you before. So what you do is you go to proxpn.com/amp. That's AMP, like advertise, market, and promote, like our AMP program here on Free Talk Live. Yeah, because $5 of your purchase when you do this goes to the AMP program. So you get 2 years worth of ProXPN service for less than $50 worth of Bitcoin. $5 of it goes to Free Talk Live's AMP program, and you get the awesome ProXPN service at a heck of a discount. I mean, you really can't beat that. If you've got Bitcoin, this is a no-brainer at this point. ProXPN.com/AMP. If you don't have Bitcoin, you can still use the code FTL50 to get the regular 50% off deal that we've been telling you about forever. So ProXPN.com/AMP. Check it out. As we continue here, you're welcome to share your thoughts on the founder of Mega Upload being attacked by the U.S. federal government. They want him withdrawn from New Zealand in extradition. And the defense in this particular case.
There are enough people in jail in the United States. We have to bring them from foreign countries.
Yeah. And so as though putting Kim.com in jail is going to somehow dissuade people from sharing music, movies, and files on the internet. I mean, isn't that the idea here? Is we're going to send a message. Just like they sent a message with Ross Ulbricht, the founder of the Silk Road, by putting him in prison for the rest of his life for running a website. I mean, this is a disturbing trend, isn't it? Like, you could argue with Silk Road that Ross Ulbricht, not only did Ross Ulbricht, the creator of the Silk Road, which is this sort of underground darknet site where you could buy and sell whatever you want, not only did he create the site, but he also sold mushrooms on the site. And that's pretty much
psilocybic mushrooms.
Yeah, that's pretty much an incontrovertible fact at this point. So somebody who wanted to could argue, well, Ross Ulbricht knew that people were using his site.
Didn't he get 25 years in prison?
No, he got life in prison.
I would argue
no parole.
That selling mushrooms on the internet is not worth life in prison.
Oh, I agree with that. Well, they're punishing him because he's the first to market. He created the Silk Road, and ever since then, the Silk Road has spawned dozens of imitators. So it's when the feds went in and shut down Silk Road, they didn't stop the selling of drugs on the internet. It just went into other sites.
Right. Well, this is the problem with the drug war generally. I mean, we've law enforcement against prohibition, when I first saw them give their little speech, and this was very convincing to me, is that, you know, when police officers, these are former police officers in many cases, talking about how they think that prohibition should be done away with. They're saying
that's right.
When they lock up a mass murderer, murderers go down. When they lock up a burglar, burglars go down. Mm-hmm. When they lock up a drug dealer, they've simply created a job opening. That the sale of drugs does not change in one iota.
Because the demand is still there.
The war on drugs has been prosecuted in, you decide how long you want to call it, but let's go for 100 years. And they have not stopped. They have not even put a dent in human beings stopping doing drugs. Now, you can look at certain areas, like let's look at tobacco, for instance. Tobacco, the use of tobacco has gone down, but it has nothing to do with the illegality of it. It
That's
has
right.
to do with education programs. The drinking of liquor actually is going down, but that has mostly to do with the reason it went up in the first place had to do with prohibition in the first place. So it's easier to transport a gallon of liquor alcohol in the form of liquor than it is in the form of beer.
Because
right?
it's concentrated.
It's concentrated, I guess.
You can sell it at a higher amount for a smaller storage space.
And so there you go. I mean, those are the ways, they're just affecting the marketplace and, in many cases, driving people to harder drugs through it. So, they really got to give this up. They're creating as many problems as they're solving, if they're solving any.
Well, they're still doing it the same old way, Mark, which is to crack down and act like they're sending some kind of message to the world, to show how tough they are, that if you mess with the U.S. federal government, if you share music and movies, you're a pirate and you're a criminal and you're a bad person. I mean, they even put these commercials on DVDs and Blu-rays these days. I don't know, you don't get the Blu-rays or whatever. I don't know if they do this online with the streaming services. I'm not sure if they do it, but do you ever see these, Mark? I know you said you've got the Netflix streaming or whatever, but
what
like
commercials you're talking about,
at, like the beginning of a Blu-ray where it's like, you wouldn't share this, you wouldn't give this away, but you share movies and you're a criminal. Like, they're kind of designed for younger people to try to dissuade them from sharing the movie that they're watching.
I have seen those ads in the past, and I question exactly, right? Is it against the law? Certainly it's against the law. Is it immoral? Those are the questions I ask myself. So if I bring you to my house and I show you a video, that's cool. If I break a DVD, they want me to buy another one. So I clearly don't own the license to this thing, right? Like
a DVD is technically licensed for home use, right? Like it's not yet licensed for.
But I don't own even the use of it personally. If I break the DVD, I have to go out and buy another one.
Yeah.
But I can't choose to just. The only thing I can do is share that DVD with another friend, but
correct.
If I decide to show it to friends for, and charge money or something like that, I can't do that.
Right.
They've just got all these rules about how it is that I can use a product. So if I want a friend to be able to see it and I want to send it digitally, so for instance, I buy things over Amazon to watch these movies. Mm-hmm. If I want you to be able to see Captain America Winter Soldier, which I purchased, I can't just let you see the one that I paid for. You have to pay
unless
for
I was
one.
At your house or you gave me your login for Amazon.
Right, that kind of thing. Yeah. So it gets very complicated. They don't really want you to own the stuff that you buy.
Mm-mm.
The online world is odd. I get how they're concerned about financing blockbuster movies and those sorts of things, but we also need to consider throwing people in prison isn't good for us generally. If Kim.com stole something and got away to New Zealand, the United States government wouldn't be chasing after him. What they're trying to do is they're working for their corporatist cronies, buddies, trying to enforce their rules. That's what it comes down to. They're using my tax dollars to...
And yours.
Yeah. Chase Listen. After this guy who's in some other country who hasn't harmed anyone. And that disturbs me.
Toll-free number tonight, if you want to join us here, if you think he has harmed people, you think this prosecution should go forward, our toll-free number, 855-450-FREE. It's the live Saturday edition of Free Talk Live. That number is 855-450-3733. Or Skype in. Skype username, lrn.fm. Currency is too important a thing to be left in the hands of government bureaucrats, especially when billions of dollars can be created with the swipe of a pen. Overstock.com supports the cryptocurrency movement because it returns the power of an inflation-proof form of money to the people, where it belongs. Did you know that you can use Bitcoin to pay for anything Overstock.com sells while enjoying free shipping on orders of 0.211 Bitcoin or more? If you support freedom and the cryptocurrency movement,
You should support Overstock.com.
If you expect secure, privacy-oriented services and real human support from your web hosting provider, choose Virtual Space International. From domain names and SSL certificates to offshore banking accounts, Virtual Space International has been the all-in-one, multi-language solution for over 25 years. And satisfaction is guaranteed or your money back. We even accept Bitcoin. Find out how to get 50% off for life at SaveTimeHosting.com.
No way. Is that a real bullet necklace?
No, it's a 9mm bullet necklace with matching earrings, you'll notice.
Those are awesome. Where'd you get them?
Dave found them at PatriotNecklace.com.
Wow.
They have a variety of calibers and necklaces and earrings and keychains.
PatriotNecklace.com?
PatriotNecklace.com.
Your choice of caliber bullet includes a rugged American-made stainless steel dog tag chain. A percentage of every sale goes to military and service-related charities. And get a discount by entering GCN at checkout. Show your patriotism and support our troops with a bullet necklace from PatriotNecklace.com.
Okay, open your mouth and say, ah.
Ah.
When your child has a sore throat, you need to know when to get help. The doctor-recommended Say Ah Sore Throat Exam is your solution. The scientifically designed oral retractor offers a clear view of the throat, relaxing the tongue, and minimizing gag reflex. Compare with a medical-grade chart, website, and app. Then you'll know just what to tell your doctor. A wellness plan in your hands in minutes. Go to SayAhNow.com. SayAhNow.com, the new mainstay for every family's first aid kit.
I've been told no in many different ways.
I give you an order and you're going to obey it.
Well, George, you can go this way.
You can't do that and you have to leave here.
You cannot bring Simon to the rally.
Walk with me.
Well, I'm comfortable here, actually.
Whoa, excuse me.
Who do you think
excuse
you are?
Excuse me.
There is no video and audio allowed in this office.
No, I have work today. This is...
You ain't going to make it.
Wait.
Out of town. Now.
Wait a minute.
Hey! Oh my God! Unbelievable!
Why are you running from me?
Because you scared me!
What am I being detained for?
You're being served.
What is this?
You're being served.
What is this?
Bureaucrats have a funny way of telling people no.
That's the sound of the men working on the chain.
Derek Jay's Victimless Crime Spree. Watch it for free and order the Director's Cut DVD at victimlesscrimespree.com.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love. But make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com.
Liberty activists around the country are starting to realize politics alone won't set us free. So what will? At Liberty on the Rocks, we believe the answer starts with living your principles, spreading ideas, and connecting with those around you. By starting a Liberty on the Rocks network, you can make a difference by uniting libertarian thinkers. Find out how much fun it is to build your local network from the ground up. Visit libertyontherocks.org today to get started.
You can put the Liberty Radio Network on the air in your area. Visit broadcast.lrn.fm to learn how. Broadcast.lrn.fm.
Yeah! It's Free Talk Live's live Saturday show. You can join us here. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE, 855-450-3733. Joining you in studio, it's Ian.
And Mark.
And don't forget to join us online over at freetalklive.com. And you want another great discounted deal for paying with Bitcoin? Because this is what Bitcoin is becoming now. It's not just another...
Yeah, it's becoming the way, essentially, a coupon currency to some extent.
It's not just the world's best currency. Because it is that. I mean, it's super easy to use it. It's international. It wasn't created by any government or any bank. It's not just internet money, because it's that too. But it's also a way to get dramatic discounts on the stuff that pretty much you were going to buy anyway. So why wouldn't you want to do it? Let's say you could get 20% off your next Amazon purchase. Would you want that? I mean, why wouldn't you?
Why, right. This is like getting a raise in life. Basically, yeah. You can buy everything you need to live life, besides like sort of paying your bills.
Yep. But
everything you need to live life on Amazon if you wanted to. And if you can save 20%, and you can very easily save 20% with everything you buy through Amazon, you might be able to get 25 or 30, depending on the situation.
I got one. Well, I'm still waiting on the products to be delivered, but I've got a couple orders that are out there right now that have been placed by people. Because what happens is you're putting your orders out for sort of a bidding process of people wanting to buy your Bitcoin, because you're paying for your goods on Amazon with Bitcoin. And there's sort of like an intermediate process that goes on at saveitpurse.com to make that possible. And so you do have to wait. So the higher amount that you want, as far as your discount is concerned, because you select, you want 40% off, you can try for 40. You want 30% off, you can go for that. Anything in between, whatever. The average in the United States is 20% off. I put one at 20%, it was snapped up within a couple hours. I put one at 30%, it was also snapped up within a few hours. So it really is not hard at all to do this. You just go to saveitpurse.com, watch their intro video.
Yep. Get your account reserved right now.
Yeah, right. You don't even have to have Bitcoin to go to saveitpurse.com to learn about how this is so easy.
But we will tell you how to get Bitcoin at
a little bit later. Yeah.
A great rate.
So go to saveitpurse.com. This is real. It's not some kind of ridiculous claim, scam, or whatever. I've used it more than 24 times myself, and it's awesome.
Yeah, we just got a big savings at our house. We bought a...
What'd you get?
Well, my son Jack had saved his money for a very long time to buy the Shield Helicarrier Lego set.
Ooh, that sounds awesome.
It's $350.
Oh my God.
It's so expensive, but it's gigantic. He just finished it. It took him 2 days of just nonstop.
Wow.
The kid would wake up. You'd have to get him to eat. This was the worst part of it. But yeah, he's constantly doing it, and he saved 20%.
On a $300-some item.
Yep, which means that he now has money left over
that
he can buy another one with.
Does Jack have his own Bitcoin wallet yet?
No, I don't.
He's a little too young for that.
He's heard about Bitcoin, doesn't really know what it means.
All right, so saveitpurse.com, it works. Anyway, you know what? I wonder if Kim.com had any Bitcoin. Because right now they're saying Kim.com, the founder of Mega Upload, who's facing extradition hearings in New Zealand to be brought to the United States to face various different copywriting criminal charges, conspiracy to commit copyright infringement, etc., conspiracy to money launder. They love to throw that one at anybody who's done anything supposedly illegal. They're coming after him and his associates. Says here that he had $60 million, but that was taken by the authorities during the raid. And the attorney who's representing him is owed more than $500,000. He's continuing to represent Mr.com, however, because the attorney is confident that he will prevail. But when they raided Kim.com's house, they also froze his bank accounts. Mm. And so there goes your $60 million. Poof. Just like that.
Yeah.
Now, if you're disturbing. Lucky...
Yeah, if you have that in Bitcoin, the government couldn't do that to you.
That's my point, is what... Like, I wonder if Kim.com was already into Bitcoin and he's just not telling anybody, and maybe he actually does have some Bitcoin on the side, but clearly he still had a whole lot of money in the old world money system, if you will, the banking system. And man, whatever you got in that bank account, you might as well kiss it goodbye, because I'm not saying don't have a bank account, but just don't expect it's going to be there tomorrow. I mean, typically it is. Most days you're going to wake up and your bank account's going to be there. But if the government decides they want to come after you, all of a sudden those funds will become unavailable.
If you use a government currency, you can expect that government to decide to take their currency back.
Anytime they feel like it, basically. And there's nothing you can do about it.
And it happens to people every day.
So let's see here. The Mr. Kim.com, the founder of Mega Upload, story here from the AP, says that his unabashedly ostentatious lifestyle was unusual in a nation which often prizes humility, and his arrest hardly seemed to slow him down. He soon released a music album, started another internet file-sharing company called Mega, and launched a political party which contested the nation's 2014 election. But over the past year, his star appears to have faded. Some of the money he made from Mega helped fund his political ambitions, which came to nothing after his party failed to win any seats in the election.
Hmm.
As major, well, I mean, you know, your first time out, you're probably not going to win the first time, right? Even if you're Kim.com. Major arguments began the hearing on Thursday. A couple dozen curious onlookers watched, including one man who seemed to enjoy the warmth of the courtroom and began to snore. Outside, a lone protester appeared from time to time, sometimes wearing a bandana, sometimes a tinfoil hat. And .com appears confident during a break after the U.S. attorney had laid out a summary of the case against him, or I guess it's actually a New Zealand attorney doing the U.S.'s bidding. He turned to a reporter and said, quote, "That sounded bad, huh? Wait till the rebuttal," unquote. So we'll keep an eye on this particular case. I'm very interested to see what happens. I find this very similar to the Ross Ulbricht case in that they're going after a man for running a website. That's the essence of the Ulbricht case, and it's the essence of Kim.com's case here.
Well, now, Kim.com is better protected.
I think, yeah, Kim.com.
Defended, I should say.
He's better defended. He's, you know, he can afford an attorney if he can actually get to his funds. Of course, that would have been the truth about Ross Ulbricht as well, if he could get to his Bitcoin. But unfortunately, the government seized a bunch of that, too, because they seized his computer and he did not have his, I don't think he had his keys completely locked down. So he was unable to, and my microphone appears to not be working. Can you still hear me, Mark, in your
nope,
headphones?
Nope, I've got you, you've dipped up okay. out of there. Yeah. Yeah. So the similarities are that Ross Ulbricht, who was the Dread Pirate Roberts, he, you know, he had put a website up, and he certainly knew what was going to go on his website. This was on the dark web. It was the Silk Road. Kim.com. The claim is that he knew that is it called Mega Upload?
Mega Upload is his old site. His new one is now mega.nz.
Yeah, that it was going to be used to put files on where people were going to file share and that sort of thing.
But they're presenting evidence showing that he did know, right? Like that,
yeah, they're claiming that, and I believe yeah. that I believe he probably did know. I think we need something. The internet is a new and disruptive force. We need new intellectual property laws. The same old copyright, the same old patent laws, the same old trademarks, these things don't serve us in the way. What they do is they serve the lawyer industrial complex. The only people who are getting rich off of this stuff are big corporations and lawyers. And I'm sick of it. It's just another way to move funds upward, up the chain into the hands of people who are extraordinarily wealthy.
And everybody knows it, right? Like anybody who's...
Well, but the serfs will continue to argue for this stuff.
Like, are they?
But I'm a photographer, and if it wasn't for intellectual property, people would steal my stuff. You take wedding pictures. People pay you to be there and take the pictures they want. There's no way they could get, you know, like, it just doesn't make any sense.
You're the
sense.
Only one with those pictures.
Free Talk Live is a show where we rely to some extent on intellectual property, but people's understanding of it, not sort of legal stuff. You know, if you want to go on our website at freetalklive.com and download our archives, feel free. If you want to serve, if you want to cut the commercials out of those archives and serve them up yourself, feel free. Do the work if that's what you want to do. If you want to cut them up and then sort of, you know, just have little tiny bits of them or put video or audio to them, whatever you want to do. There's all kinds of people that do that online. We don't stop them.
If you want to put it on a YouTube channel and monetize it, I don't care.
Just
yeah, whatever.
That's
if
what
you
it comes
can make
down
money
to.
Off the show, then go for it, man. So I sure don't have time to do all that stuff.
It's just, it you know, that's what it ultimately comes down to is that it's trying to get businesses trying to get the government to enforce their intellectual property rules for them.
Well, obviously we know that the Recording Industry Association and their family members are going to be in favor of intellectual property laws. They might be in favor of going after Mr. Mega Upload here. But as far as the average person in America, I mean, I think most people understand that it's not there's nothing wrong with downloading a movie and screening that movie. Like, if you love the movie, then go buy it. Don't people understand that? Like, if you don't give money to the band you love, they're going to stop playing music at some point. You know, they might not schedule any more concerts if no one's coming out, if no one's buying the t-shirts, if no one is buying, you know, what was it? Which band was it that put their, was it Nine Inch Nails or Green Day? One or the other. Anyway, they put... it wasn't Green Day. Anyway, Nine Inch Nails, I think, did it at one point. Trent Reznor, they put an album online, and you could just, like, donate whatever you wanted for it, right? Wasn't that them?
Well, I don't know who it was. I couldn't tell you, but it's a great
Radiohead?
Idea.
Was it Radiohead?
It's a great idea. When you think about it for a second, what does the band get for, the release of an album? What do
if
they
it's
get
through
per,
a record company, it's pennies.
Right. What do they get per album?
Well, probably chances, less than a quarter or something.
Very, very little. This is why you'll see, I believe it was MC Hammer. He did really, really well just selling his music out of like the back of his car before he hit it big. Obviously, at some point, distribution is an issue, but they don't have music stores anymore.
Yeah.
When I was in high school, I went to the music store and I'd, you know, check out Specs or Camelot Music and, you know, all these cool places. Daddy Cool Records and Tapes.
Nobody knows what these things are anymore.
Right. Like kids don't go there anymore. They don't get their music in the same way.
You had to go into a store and put on headphones used by other people to actually hear what the music sounded like? Yeah. Yeah,
that
you
was
did.
That was exactly what it was.
And
like.
It was cool.
That was the good that was the good store that had the headphones, by the way, that you could listen to.
It's Free Talk Live. I think that we've got some sort of connections issues here with our network because we have blown over time by more than a minute. So I don't know what is going on here.
Oh hey!
Oh
look.
Hey! Look!
Now I can hear myself. I can hear myself.
New Hampshire is under quarantine as walking corpses devour the flesh of the living. Max is 11 years old and surviving alone. Slow moving and non-thinking, the dead swarm his home. Now he must apply his Porcupine Freedom Scouts training to improvise his escape. Look for Survivor Max on Facebook, read reviews on Amazon, or read Chapter 1 at SurvivorMax.com.
You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone, 213-493-0308. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The Listen Lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number two is next, after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Saturday, September 26th, 2015. Silver is trading at $15.12 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,146 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $237. Antiwar.com reports, speaking Thursday to the Senate Intelligence Committee, NSA Chief Admiral Michael Rogers claimed that a potential government shutdown was a threat to national security on the grounds that the NSA might lose employees to the private sector if that happens. Rogers claims that NSA employees are so great that they could easily get much better jobs outside of the NSA and that many are likely to do so if they believe the shutdown is going to threaten their pay, meaning the agency could lose significant numbers of workers. At the core, Rogers' complaint largely echoes some of the government agency chiefs who are opposed to the shutdown because they don't want to see their agency's funding threatened or, worse yet, see them shut down for a period of time long enough that the public realizes that what they're doing isn't really missed when it's gone. That's the real threat to the NSA, in particular with so much of their activity done entirely in secret and the public only having the government's word for it that what the NSA is doing is actually important. The question could quickly be brought to the fore with a shutdown, and particularly with all the objectionable things the NSA is known to do, their value is already a subject of debate.
For over 35 years, Roberts & Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co.
UPI reports Texas correction officials on Friday admitted that they have supplied doses of a lethal drug to the state of Virginia for an execution there, but refused to disclose how they obtained the chemical. Officials said three vials of the drug pentobarbital were given to the Virginia Department of Corrections. Pentobarbital is a barbiturate often used in lethal injections that can cause death in high doses. On Friday, the Texas Department of Criminal Justice acknowledged that it shared the drug with Virginia, but refused to disclose where they had obtained the pentobarbital. Virginia is scheduled to execute an inmate next week, its first in 2 years. The Texas Department of Criminal Justice said state law prohibits the agency from disclosing the identity of the supplier of lethal injection drugs. Friday's disclosure came a day after attorneys for Oklahoma death row inmate Richard Glossop filed court papers claiming the Texas government is now manufacturing its own lethal injection drugs and it is sharing them with Virginia. Glossop is scheduled to be executed on September 30th, barring a last-minute reprieve. Oklahoma will use the drug midazolam to aid in his execution, but Glossop has requested pentobarbital, which is considered to be more reliable in executions since it appears that Texas is able to supply the drug.
You can support FPP Radio by joining the Fans program. Fans are friends, allies, and Numeri supporters. Fans help FPP afford to produce more original content. You can join the Fans program for as little as $3 per month or any amount of Bitcoin per month, thanks to the recurring payment options provided by Coinbase. To learn more or to join the Fans program, visit fans.fppradio.com. That's fans.fppradio.com.
Reuters reports House Speaker John Boehner will leave Congress at the end of October after struggling with repeated rebellions by conservatives during a tumultuous 5-year reign as the chamber's top Republican. The 65-year-old congressman from Ohio stunned Republican House members at a meeting on Friday morning with the announcement that he would resign his seat effective October 30th. U.S. Representative Kevin McCarthy of California, the number 2 House Republican, quickly became the leading contender to replace Boehner as Speaker. While loyal to Boehner, McCarthy has built personal relationships with conservative groups and tacked right recently to back the shutdown of the Export-Import Bank. Boehner has faced constant pressure from conservatives who believe he was too willing to compromise with President Obama and too frequently relied on Democratic votes to pass crucial legislation. Boehner told reporters he was stepping aside to avoid another brewing House battle over his leadership. Conservatives had threatened a revolt and possible government shutdown over spending next week. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
A report released Tuesday by physicists at Stanford University revealed that the entire known universe, from the whole of human civilization to the totality of matter and energy, is actually the fictional setting of a cop show called Hard Case. According to authors of the report, existence as we know it was created solely to provide the framework for the primetime drama that airs weekly in a parallel universe, and that every historical event prior to the show's September 2008 pilot, including the Renaissance, World War II, evolution, the September 11th attacks, and the presidential administrations of Washington through Clinton, never actually happened and are merely part of the elaborate backstory crafted by Hard Case creator and showrunner Dominic Egan.
We used to believe that our universe operated under immutable laws of thermodynamics and gravitational relativity, but now we know everything just comes from the minds of Hard Case's 12 staff writers. Overall, it seems like a very well-written show.
Physicists have theorized that the universe as we know it will cease to exist whenever Hard Case airs its final episode.
This is the Onion News Network.
Free Talk Live.
It's Free Talk Live. And despite something breaking at our network studios, I believe we are still on the radio wave. So you can still join us here, presuming the toll-free lines are working, at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Although I got to say, I recommend Skype. Yes, it can be monitored by the FBI. Okay, we know that. It's Microsoft. But it still sounds pretty darn good. And if you're going to call a radio show, then
Your phone can be monitored by the FBI, too.
That's true. And anybody can listen to you on the radio, so it doesn't matter how you call us. You can use the phone, but Skype is really sounds good. So use Skype username LRN.FM. Some people in certain religions, including some Mormons, are freaking out over this so-called blood moon. And I want to talk about that, but you know what? There's also in the news, it's the same old story everybody's heard a zillion times about the government spending too damn much money on a bunch of stuff that shouldn't cost that much. You know, the old golden hammer story.
It should be golden. It wasn't.
WashingtonTimes.com has this, and the article is actually entitled, or it's got actually the picture of the golden hammer at the top of the story headline, EPA's fondness for high-end furniture costs taxpayers $92 million. The federal agency, reports Kellen Howell at the Times, has the job of protecting the environment doesn't seem to have too much concern for trees, at least the ones cut down to make their furniture. The Environmental Protection Agency over the past decade has spent a whopping $92.4 million to purchase, rent, and install and store office furniture ranging from fancy hickory chairs and a hexagonal wooden table worth thousands of dollars each to a simple drawer to store pencils that cost $813.57.
Doesn't it seem like, I mean, maybe I'm going crazy here, but it seems like the government should, you know, have one supplier or, you know, one sort of standard type of thing that it buys. These are the kind of chairs we buy. These are the kind of chairs we buy with wheels. These are the kind of chair. These are the kind of filing cabinets we buy. These are the 2 high filing cabinets, the 3 high filing cabinets, the 4 high filing cabinets. This is the kind of desk we purchase. This is the kind of executive desk we purchase, right? Like, these are just the things that they would have. You know, they don't buy pictures. You want pictures? Bring your pictures in from home. You want to hang up a diploma? Fine. But they, you know, there'd just be some standard things.
Mm-hmm.
This is the coffee table. This is the end table. This is the lamp. This is the floor lamp.
Yeah, but wouldn't that also sort of, I mean, obviously that's going to centralize decision making even further, but if they're getting it from one particular provider, then that just is going to lead to more high costs, right?
Well, I would think what they would be able to do is that the providers, like, you know, the government has very specialized things they ask for when they ask for stuff. So they'll just type this up one time, and yes, it'll probably take them 3 months to do it. But they type up what it is that they want as far as our office furniture one time, and then businesses can compete in how to provide that for them. If somebody wants to finish it in this thing or finish it in that thing, that's fine. But essentially, you know, the contract goes out. We need this many things. Please fulfill. And then, you know, they come back.
Our toll-free number, if you want to share your ridiculous government spending story, our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. The furniture shopping sprees equaled about $6,000 for every one of the agency's 15,492 employees, according to the federal spending data made public by the government watchdog OpenTheBooks.com. Can you imagine if you had $6,000 to spend on office furniture? I mean, how luxurious your office would end up being in
that'd
that
be
particular
nice.
Case?
Yeah. It doesn't sound crazy if you're talking about sort of an executive or something like that.
This is for every one of their employees. They did the division, and it breaks down to $6,000 for every single employee. And the EPA doesn't just buy any old office furniture. Most of the agency's contracts are with Michigan-based retailer Herman Miller Incorporated.
Nice.
According to the contract, you've heard of them?
Yeah, Herman Miller. It's good stuff.
The EPA spent $48.4 million on furnishings from the retailer known for its high-end modern furniture designs.
I like it, yeah.
Just one of Herman Miller's Aeron office chairs retails for nearly $730 on the store's website.
You know, a good chair, in my opinion, is worth it. I'm fine with spending a good amount of money on an office chair.
Yeah.
But I don't know how long they last and how long they keep them and these kind of things. This is an issue. If you pay good money for office equipment, it should last longer.
Well, yeah, but you know how the government works. I mean, if they want to get their budget the next year, they've got to blow out the entire budget this year.
Yep.
And so if they want to get more furniture, they're probably turning through this like every year or two or something.
Yeah,
like
they
that.
Should have a this just shows the inefficiencies of government. As far as I'm concerned, they should have the amount of money that they're outfitted per person, and that amount, you know, if that person stays on for 10 years or whatever, they should only get that per position every 10 years or something.
The agency also paid another high-end retailer, Knoll Incorporated, nearly $5 million for furnishings. And Knoll is known for its specialized modern furnishings, and all of its 40 designs are on permanent display in the Museum of Modern Art in New York. Adam Andresky, the founder of OpenTheBooks.com, says, quote, "While private companies and citizens face more and more hardship from government regulation, the EPA literally sits in the easy chair. They can't relate to the financial hardships regular Americans face. It's Herman Miller furniture for the bureaucrats, but IKEA for the taxpayers." unquote, for spending tens of millions of dollars to furnish federal buildings like Wall Street hedge fund offices at taxpayers' expense. The EPA wins this week's Golden Hammer, a weekly distinction awarded by the Washington Times, highlighting the most egregious examples of wasteful spending. Now, what I thought was noteworthy about this story is it's the same old story that has been told so many times about government. Not just federal government, but state and local governments are guilty of this overspending stuff too. I'm sure the feds are probably the worst at it on average just because they have more money
to
spend.
They're least accountable.
And they're the least accountable. But how many times does this have to happen? It just keeps happening. And it doesn't matter how often or to what extent or how many millions of dollars or whatever. It just doesn't matter. People get all upset about it. They've even got an award they're offering on a weekly basis at the Washington Times for the most ridiculous story. And so people get upset about it. Talk radio makes a big deal about it or whatever. Like, oh, these wasteful federal bureaucrats.
The late night comedy shows love to make hay over it, too.
Yeah, it's great material. There's no doubt.
Politicians will make an, you know, we'll say, you know what, if you elect me, I'm not like the rest of those liars and thieves. I will fix the problem. Right, you know what? Here, I'll break an ashtray to prove it. Al Gore actually did that at one point. But it's just, you know.
How'd that work out?
It's gone so far that you just don't expect anything else.
Right.
I walked by when I was younger. I was in New York. I walked by the UN building. I saw, and I don't remember which country it was, other than to say that it was a poor African country. I can't remember which one it was. It's been too long. But some poor African country had a 7 Series BMW out there with its flags on the front of it. And I'm thinking, man, I wonder how many of their people they could have fed for this stinking car.
Let's go to Randy in Indianapolis. You're on Free Talk Live listening to WIBC. Hello, Randy.
Hi, guys. How are you?
Welcome, sir. Go ahead with your thoughts.
So I own my own company, a party rental company, and we have done some government contracts. The reason that it is so expensive and the government has to spend so much money is it's such a mess of paperwork and so many hoops you have to jump through to actually service the government that you have to charge a premium to make it worth your time to actually make a profit.
So you're saying the average government contract is more work than the typical buyer?
Oh, yeah, most definitely. I mean, I could have a residential job call me up, you know, send them a quote, send them a contract, everything's, you know, good to go. For my government contracts, it's send them a quote, get a proposal back from them, send one back and forth, and then, you know, there's just heaps of paperwork that you have to provide, and it's at least another hour of paperwork to do alone for just something really basic.
Yeah, but isn't, I mean, okay, I get where you're coming from. It's a hassle to deal with the government, no doubt. But you also know you can get more out of them, right? Like, you know that you can double the price or whatever, and even though you're spending an extra hour doing the division, you're still coming out pretty far ahead, right?
Right. I mean, some companies may do that. You know, they look at a way to take advantage. Me, personally, our company, we charge the same rate for our equipment.
Yeah, good on you.
Government or residential, you know.
I appreciate that, Randy, and thanks for calling and sharing your experience here tonight. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Randy says dealing with the government's a huge hassle, so they should charge more. It's Free Talk Live.
Every once in a while, you get information that's worth changing your life for. This is one such time. You can save up to and beyond 25% on all purchases at Amazon. You probably heard of Bitcoin and just not thought much about it. You certainly know that you can get competitive pricing at Amazon, but now you can get a 25% discount on nearly everything you need to live. I've just given you a huge raise, and all you have to do is claim it. You go to saveitpurse.com and open an account. Do this right now. Don't wait. Then you fund the account with Bitcoin. You can buy them through expresscoin.com with a check or money order. There are other ways to get Bitcoin, but that's fast, safe, and easy. This information is worth you changing the way you do things. Go to saveitpurse.com right now, get signed up, and cash in on the huge raise I'm offering you. 15 to 25% off of everything at Amazon through saveitpurse.com. It's saveatpurse.com.
That's the sound your brain makes when you realize you're buying something and forgot the coupon. Online or in a store, knowing that you're missing a deal is the worst. You need the app from RetailMeNot right now. Get thousands of coupons from 50,000 stores like Kohl's, Domino's, Best Buy, and more with crazy deals like 60% off, free shipping, and free gifts with purchase. You can get a text invite to download the RetailMeNot app 100% free right now for Apple or Android. Just text the code UPDATE to 42767. Then just show your phone at checkout to save. It literally couldn't be easier. It's 2015. Keep your coupons in your phone. Stop what you're doing and text UPDATE to 42767. Listeners will get a text with a link to download it 100% free. Never forget another coupon again. Text the code UPDATE to 42767 right now. That's UPDATE to 42767. Message and data rates may apply. For terms and privacy, visit RetailMeNot.com.
This message is for home intruders, the cowards who break into people's homes to steal their hard-earned property, criminals who shatter lives and rob people of their privacy and security. Listen very carefully. We're the home security experts at LiveWatch, and we're taking you down. Because we're letting everyone try our newest home security system for one full year in their home. To take advantage of this amazing offer, call now, 1-800-670-9259. LiveWatch has been helping protect homes for years, and we've learned the secrets that intruders like you don't want people to know. Criminals, it's time for you to be afraid, because every person who calls will be protected against cowards like you. To the criminals listening, we're taking you down. To those who want to help protect their homes, call the security experts to try the LiveWatch security system. There are no long-term contracts, and if you're not completely satisfied, you can cancel at any time. Try LiveWatch now by calling 1-800-670-9259. That's 1-800-670-9259.
Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com.
I love My Magic Mud. I drink a lot of coffee. I had stains on my teeth. Then I found My Magic Mud, and I was told it would remove stains. So I paid attention when I brushed the first time. My Magic Mud is black tooth powder, and the difference it made in my teeth in one application was noticeable. With four, my teeth were as white as you normal folks out there. Please go to MyMagicMud.com and buy a jar. There's 150 applications for $25. You can use Bitcoin. MyMagicMud.com.
You can connect with the Liberty Radio Network via our Facebook page at facebook.lrn.fm. That's facebook.lrn.fm.
Join us here on Free Talk Live, toll free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. You can also call us up on Skype. Our Skype username is lrn.fm. We go back to your phones in a moment.
So I'm headed out to Las Vegas at the end of October for the Bitcoin Investor Conference. Now, there's going to be lots of great speakers there telling people how to, you know, what good investments there are and ways to use their money, predicting the markets, these sorts of things. It's going to be a lot of fun. It's even for the beginners are going to learn a great deal about Bitcoin. Speakers like Trace Mayer, Dr. Stephanie Murphy, Bitcoin Bell, former co-host, so is Dr. Stephanie Murphy, actually, Joseph Von Perling, Paul Pui, Tone Vase. It's going to be a great lineup. And it's at the D Hotel, where they take Bitcoin, in downtown Las Vegas, Nevada. So come, join me. See the first time we've ever done a live Free Talk Live from Las Vegas. It's October the 29th and 30th at the D Hotel in downtown Las Vegas. You can get your tickets by going to BitcoinInvestor.com. It's BitcoinInvestor.com. Should be a lot of fun, BitcoinInvestor.com.
Talking about the government waste, which, of course, just continues unabated, let's go to your calls and thoughts. Joe, listening in Grand Rapids, Michigan, to WTKG. Hey, Joe.
Yeah, this, you know, it's easy to be generous with other people's money, and that's the problem. There's no accountability. Whenever they say they've made cuts, they've just cut the rate of growth.
That's right.
Or the rate of spending. This like these desks and these office furniture, they should have some generic desk. Here's a desk. Here's a chair. If you want something different, you buy it yourself. Mm. That's the way it should be. And it's just absolutely insane. If we could figure out how much money the government spends or just blows, or there's redundancy as far as different agencies providing the same services or similar services, you know, who knows how big a dent it would make in the national debt. I mean,
well, it's $92 million over 10 years in the EPA alone just for furniture. So that doesn't include their laptops. That doesn't include, you know, whatever else it is that they, you know, they would be using as business tools, etc. Just the furniture alone, $92 million over 10 years, $6,000 per employee.
They get clothing allowances. They'll get, you know, I'm sure they get their travel expenses and stuff with reimbursed.
Oh, yeah.
Which is fine, but. You know, if the government was a business, they'd be out of business.
Absolutely.
The Pentagon just this week, there was some people, bureaucrats from the Pentagon got in all kinds of trouble for using their government credit cards for strippers and
that's not included these days. I'm surprised.
Yeah, it was the other thing. Gambling.
Oh, yeah,
that's another thing, not included. And so there was all kinds of that. And of course, you know what the Secret Service is doing. And there was another great story of the DEA down in Colombia having parties with hookers that were paid for by the cartels. The DEA agents having parties with hookers paid for by the cartel.
Right.
Well, that's not a conflict of interest.
I'm just waiting for the collapse because they can't keep it up forever. You know, they can't keep the interest rate
We've
low.
We've all got our fingers crossed on that one.
The state as an organization has been doing this for as long as the state has been around.
Yeah, they keep those plates in the air, that's
the
for
king's
sure.
men have availed themselves of the taxpayers' money for as long as there have been kings and as long as there have been king's men.
Thanks, Joe, for your call tonight, man. I appreciate hearing from you. Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. The story coming out of the Washington Times with their Golden Hammer Award being given to the EPA for just this week. Apparently, they do this every single week over there. Pete Sepp, the president of the National Taxpayers Union, says, quote, apparently, the long arm of the regulatory state needs a lot of comfortable chairs and desks to rest its collective elbow on, and the EPA's elbow print is a big one. The EPA, of course, defended its spending, saying the agency, I'm surprised they even commented, saying the agency needed the furniture after it moved buildings. Because you can't move furniture.
No, you can't move furniture. I mean, I've moved houses before, and it's impossible to get a big yellow truck for a couple hundred dollars, load it up with stuff, and move it across town. You just can't do that crap.
Quote, the EPA takes its fiscal responsibility seriously.
As we saw. As seriously as it takes poisoning rivers in Colorado.
Yeah.
We poison rivers.
As a result.
You know, but you so much as spill some motor oil on the ground and we will have your butt.
Well, that's the real reason that river got poisoned, Mark, is because the EPA employees were too busy arguing over whether they wanted felt coverings or satin coverings for their new furniture in the office. They say, quote, the EPA takes its fiscal responsibility seriously. As a result of GSA leases expiring, numerous EPA offices were required to move or consolidate space between the year 2000 and 2014. That's a near 15-year time frame that they were required to move. New furniture purchases provided the agency the opportunity to obtain space efficiencies. So
this is about efficiency.
So it's efficient to throw away, because you know that's what happened to the old furniture, right? It's not like you're going to go and take a desk to an auction and get that much money for it at a government auction. They're probably throwing a bunch of it out.
Well, even if they do hold an auction in the building and people come and get it, it's effectively thrown away in the sense that the price tag is going to be
pennies
from,
on the dollar.
I don't know what they paid for this Herman Miller desk, but they paid a lot.
Yeah.
And I don't know what they're selling it for, but they're selling it for a little. I'm guessing when you're talking about a big office full of furniture being sold, you're talking about these things going at $10 to $50 a piece would be my guess.
The EPA's problem is not new. In 2003, an internal report by Public Employees for Environmental Responsibility warned the agency to cut back on spending for fancy furniture. At the time, one employee was quoted saying in the report, quote, the amount of money that the EPA's Office of Criminal Enforcement, Forensics, and Training wastes is mind-boggling. The employee added the ability of agents to investigate violations is negatively affected by a number of wasteful practices, including, quote, moving and remodeling offices and buying fancy new furniture for the benefit of a favored few. Among the thousands of contracts for household and office furniture were a hexagonal table that clocked in at $5,500.
That's a nice table.
Hickory chairs for $6,000. A gallery lounge chair, and I'm rounding down on these numbers, by the way. A gallery lounge chair with gallery settee at $2,600 for the set, and a pencil drawer at over $800.
Hmm.
One of the contracts called for a Herman Miller chair with adjustable arm, swivel, lumber, caster, and tilt, costing over $4,000.
Yeah, that seems like a lot. Those Arion chairs are pretty nice, but it makes you wonder.
Well, but that's not all.
Well, the federal government, I can't remember what the number was, but it was just an incredible number of people that are being paid over $100,000, bureaucrats that work there. So, you know, if you're getting paid that kind of money, your expectation is that you're going to have that kind of chair. There's just no check on these people for what they spend. All their job is to take money from you.
And spend it.
And then spend it supposedly back on you and take a cut for themselves. Well, what a surprise. They take a healthy cut.
A big cut. And it seems to get bigger over time. In fact, here's another interesting spend on the EPA's part. They also spent big money to simply move and store their fancy chairs and desks. In one example, the agency paid $73,000 to move the furniture out of an Ann Arbor, Michigan office just so they could replace the carpeting.
I wish I got these moving contracts. $74,000?
Yeah, just to move the furniture out, replace the carpet, and then move it back in. And I don't think that included the replacing of the carpet in the price. 855-450-FREE. It's Free Talk Live.
Okay, open your mouth and say, ah.
Ah. When your child has a sore throat, you need to know when to get help. The doctor recommended Say Aw Sore Throat Exam is your solution. The scientifically designed oral retractor offers a clear view of the throat, relaxing the tongue and minimizing gag reflex. Compare with a medical grade chart, website, and app. Then you'll know just what to tell your doctor. A wellness plan in your hands in minutes. Go to SayAhNow.com. SayAhNow.com, the new mainstay for every family's first aid kit.
No way. Is that a real bullet necklace?
No, it's a 9mm bullet necklace with matching earrings, you'll notice.
Those are awesome. Where'd you get them?
Dave found them at PatriotNecklace.com.
Wow.
They have a variety of calibers and necklaces and earrings and keychains.
PatriotNecklace.com?
PatriotNecklace.com.
Your choice of caliber bullet includes a rugged American-made stainless steel dog tag chain. A percentage of every sale goes to military and service-related charities. And get a discount by entering GCN at checkout. Show your patriotism and support our troops with a bullet necklace from PatriotNecklace.com.
Keenvention is coming up fast, October 30th through November 1st. Get your tickets now at keenvention.info. Keenvention is an intimate event where you can meet dozens of key liberty activists from across the Shire, including Oathkeeper Chris Reitman, Libertarian presidential candidate Daryl W. Perry, illegal Uber driver Christopher David, NeoCash Radio's Dr. Darren Tapp, State Representative Mike Silvia, rated an A+ by the NHLA, The Seditious Sirens, The Rebel Love Show's Rob Mathias, Tech Guru Brian Sovereign, Cop Blocker J.P. Freeman, New Mover Dr. Taryn Lupo, longtime political activist Dennis Goddard, Church of the Invisible Hand Minister Rich Paul, Shire Dude, and dozens more. Only 100 tickets are available in advance, so lock yours in now for just $60 or with Bitcoin. That includes access to the Hallokeen costume dance party. Reserve your tickets now at keenvention.info. Visit keenvention.info for more speaker announcements or look for our page and event on Facebook. That's keenvention.info.
This is your Roberts & Roberts Brokerage Daily Precious Metals Update. In early trading Friday, gold is $6 lower at $1,147 per ounce. Silver is down 2 cents at $15.18 per ounce. Bitcoin is trading at $236. The prospect for getting ahead on silver American Eagles looks bad, but we have plenty of spiders, Britannias, and kangaroos in stock. Give us a call at 800-874-9760 or visit us online at rrbi.co.
LRN.fm is proud to announce our official listening apps for Android and iOS devices. Now you can easily tune into our streams anywhere, anytime on your smartphone or tablet. Just visit apps.lrn.fm or search for LRN.fm in the Android or Apple app stores. Please download, rate it 5 stars, then share the link on social media, and let your friends and family know how you're listening to LRN.FM. Download it now, free at apps.lrn.fm. That's apps.lrn.fm.
Free Press Publications is an independent, alternative media and publishing company founded in June 2009 with the mission of ensuring a free press for the freedom movement and is committed to spreading the message of peace, freedom, love, and liberty. FPP also gives new authors an avenue for publishing freedom-oriented material. FPP brings you daily news and commentary on the website fpp.cc, as well as a daily 5-minute newscast, FPP Radio News, and weekly news, views, and commentary in the FPP Freedom Minute and Peace, Love, Liberty Radio at fppradio.com, and the monthly newspaper FPP News at news.fpp.cc. Find FPP online at fpp.cc. That's fpp.cc, as in Creative Commons.
While our satellite channel is free to listen to, it's not free for us. You can help us cover our satellite costs with the chip-in on the right side of the page at lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. It's the live Saturday edition of the program. Our toll-free number for you to join us here is 855-450-FREE. We're talking about the same old story of government waste, except this time the numbers and the bureaucracy have changed. That's all. That's the only thing that changes is, oh, it's this government bureaucracy has been caught wasting money. Wow. Shocking. It's outrageous. And it is outrageous. And maybe for people who've never heard a story like this before, it's shocking, but it's certainly not shocking for us. We've been doing this show for more than a decade, and we've seen our share of these stories.
I think people are jaded to this topic. I think that the expectation is that the government's just going to spend money, ridiculous amounts of money, when it does this. It's bloated. Yeah. The one guy who called in and said that it costs more to do to do stuff with the government, the business right. owner, he's like, of course it costs. Of course we charge more to the government.
Well, he said he didn't. Well, he said his business didn't.
He said there was a premium is what he put on it.
Okay.
But he didn't. He claimed that he didn't put an unreasonable premium, and that's fine. Mm-hmm. But at least he's saying, at the very least, what he's saying is that it's hard to work with the government because they're so ponderous and bureaucratic. Part of the reason it costs all this money is because God knows how many hoops the company had to jump through just to be able to move the furniture or whatever it was that they were doing.
In the case of the EPA, they've spent more than $92 million over the last decade on office furniture, fancy furniture that is as much as $5,000 for a simple table. The table, a hexagonal table. Okay, it's got six sides, so that's almost $6,000. It's almost $6,000. It's about $1,000 per side.
Per side.
On that thing. And then $73,000 just to move furniture from an office in Ann Arbor, Michigan, so they could then replace the carpet and ultimately move the furniture back into it. The story coming from the Washington Times. We'll continue it here in a moment. I also want to let you know where to get Bitcoin. We talked earlier about how you can save big money on certain things by paying with Bitcoin, like at saveatpurse.com, where you can save 20% or more on Amazon. You've got to get the Bitcoin, though, so to do that, go to expresscoin.com. ExpressCoin is the best choice for getting your cryptocurrencies, including Bitcoin, Litecoin, Dogecoin. It's fast, safe, easy, and inexpensive. They're a licensed money services business. I've used them. Mark, you have used them multiple times as well. And you can get your cryptocurrencies with money order or check. It's very easy. Just get started at expresscoin.com, whether you're in the U.S. or Canada. That's expresscoin.com. They've got a smartphone app, and you can use coupon code FTL, like Free Talk Live, to get up to $40 worth of cryptocurrency with no transfer fee at all. So use expresscoin.com. Coupon code FTL. As we go to your calls and thoughts, John is listening in Virginia Beach. You're on Free Talk Live. Hello, John.
Hey, I just wanted to call in about this new tool that was recently released for Bitcoin. It's called ProTip. Mm-hmm. I don't know if you're familiar with ChangeTip. It's a Bitcoin tipping service that allows you to send a nickel or a dime to somebody if you like a YouTube comment or a Facebook post or something.
Right.
And this is along those lines, except it's automatic. So if I'm watching a Free Talk Live episode on YouTube, which I do every day, if there's a Bitcoin address in that, then it will automatically record that and then set a timer to determine how much of your time you spend doing that. And then every week it divides up a preset weekly donation among the websites that you visit based on how much time you spend. And it only has, I think it has, this technology has potential to be pretty groundbreaking. I don't think I'm the best advocate for it, but
fascinating. I have not heard about this. I did just Google it as you mentioned it here, and it is getting some headlines in the Bitcoin universe. It looks like they're running an Indiegogo. Are you aware of this?
They did. They raised $12,000, most of it through Bitcoin, and that was a few months ago. Mm-hmm. And they just finished and released the software. They're still accepting donations.
So, so you're saying it'll somehow detect that if we put a Bitcoin logo in, or that we put a QR code or something on our YouTube channel or in the video content itself?
It does either QR codes or Bitcoin addresses, and it it will automatically detect it. You have to use Google Chrome, and it's, the software is built into Chrome as an extension.
So let's talk a little bit more about this micropayment thing. This is one of the things that Bitcoin can do that the old systems can't do.
Right. If you read an article, sort of what is it worth to you to have enjoyed an article?
Not much.
Yeah, not too much. You're not going to want to spend a dollar every time you enjoy an article.
Right, a newspaper still less than a
dollar. A nickel or a dime to somebody, and that is sort of, you know, that's a fair thing to do. To if, you know, somebody writes something that you enjoy, you know, throw them a nickel.
Sure.
What's the big deal? You know, you wouldn't bend over to pick it up. So, you know, that's convenient. Now, what it needs to be is sort of automatic. And that's the
difficult. Sounds like that's what this pro tip is making it.
That's the difficult part of it. But, you know, if you can just click something and send a nickel, that's kind of cool. It makes it fast and easy for you. But if you have to go through trying to send a nickel through a credit card, it's going to charge you 80 cents to send the nickel. So you're going to spend 80 cents to send a MasterCard and Visa. You know, this legacy...
It may not be 80 cents, but it'll probably be at least 30 or 40 cents or something like that.
These legacy systems were never intended to be used online. The credit cards, they're too insecure, and they were never intended to be used online.
This is why some stores will say, you know, smaller stores, small kind of mom-and-pop operations will have a sign up at the register that says, you know, you must have at least a $5 minimum purchase to use a credit card, because they know that a fifth of that purchase is going to get eaten up by fees.
Yeah, they do know that.
Or whatever.
They ought to know that.
John, thanks for bringing that to the table. So have you tried the software yet? Have you tested it out?
Yes. I'm one of only 150 people who have donated it, but I think if a few thousand people, which isn't ridiculous in terms of the size of the Bitcoin community, I think this could really and people have to start posting addresses on their content. But I'll just give the website real quick. It is protip.is, and you can download it for free. It takes about 10 seconds, and it's pretty neat.
Very cool. Thanks for the call tonight, John. I appreciate the heads up. So, yeah, the Bitcoin allows you to go ahead and send out micropayments, and basically there's near zero fees. That's the thing with Bitcoin, is that maybe if you're new to Bitcoin, you don't know this, near zero is the fee on Bitcoin. When I say near zero, I'm talking about
fractions,
one or two cents, maybe
the
three max.
Of a penny. I mean, you can
No. It generally comes out to the standard tip for Bitcoin. It usually comes out to about 2 cents.
Tip? What do you mean?
Not tip. The transaction fee.
That depends on the ones you use. When I use the software, I can use a Satoshi, and that will get you above the sort of threshold of
really.
Yeah, absolutely.
Okay, I generally use the standard fee, which is like 0.00001 Bitcoin, and that comes out to like two cents.
Yeah.
So if that's sort of like the industry standard, I'll go with that. I don't feel like that's a problem necessarily, and that's way cheaper than any kind of credit card fees or whatever. I mean, even at 2 cents mark, that's a fraction of the fees that you would pay.
Sure, but if I'm sending a 5 cent tip, I don't particularly want to send a 2 cent
tip. No, I see what you're
saying. To get my 5 cent tip processed.
Yep.
No, I see where you're coming from on that. And yes, you're right, Mark. You can set the fees. But you know, when if I'm pitching Bitcoin to somebody, I'm going to be realistic and I'm going to tell them what the standard fee typically is.
Sure.
And that's usually like
that's
a two-cent fee. So, you know, that makes it easy to do this stuff and collect these micropayments, which should open up a new world of funding for independent producers, people who are out there producing media, you know, writers who are freelance, for instance, or, you know, podcasters or whatever, to give them an additional method of bringing revenue in that otherwise they wouldn't have been able to do before Bitcoin. And so this is one of the myriad of benefits of Bitcoin. There are a lot of them. If you want to learn more about Bitcoin, I recommend you go to Bitcoin.com. They just actually launched a new forum over there. And Bitcoin.com, it's a great sort of intro site to Bitcoin. But the new forum, they're actually doing a contest like basically between now and the end of the year for whoever it has the most popular post on the forum. Like you can like or thank someone for their post.
Appreciate, I think, is
the
term.
Appreciate. Whoever is the most appreciated post can win $1,000 worth of Bitcoin. So get posting over at forum.bitcoin.com. More Free Talk Live coming up.
The following is an important free offer for smokers only. The makers of O2Pure, the world's most advanced e-cigarette, have just authorized the release of free starter kits to all smokers who call in the next 10 minutes. Valued at $99, these starter kits are available for free, but only while supplies last. To guarantee your free kit, call in the next 10 minutes, 1-800-717-9859. The revolutionary O2Pure design creates only water vapor. There is no foul-smelling smoke and no nasty tar. This allows individuals to enjoy the nicotine they love whenever and wherever they are. The financial advantages over cigarettes are considerable as well. It is estimated that the average smoker can save hundreds of dollars a month with O2Pure. Again, free starter kits are now available to any smoker who calls in the next 10 minutes. This is a radio-only offer not available in stores, so call now for your free kit. 1-800-717-9859. 1-800-717-9859. 1-800-717-9859.
Healthy, organic, fresh fish, robust, mouth-watering vegetables, all from your home. It's called aquaponics. This brilliant, self-sustaining protein and veggie system is perfect for year-round growing. Know exactly where your food is coming from. AquaponicsSource.com is the one-stop shop for all your needs. Fish, fish food, plumbing, full systems, classes, and more. Learn to build your own system. Go to AquaponicsSource.com for a free guide to aquaponics. That's AquaponicsSource.com.
Silver has always been nature's very own antibiotic, and only one system allows you to produce an endless supply of nano-sized silver solutions right from the convenience of your home. Silver Lungs. With the addition of our unique lung delivery system, respiratory infections are targeted directly, where traditional oral administration simply cannot reach. This pioneering method also preserves the original particle sizes and delivers your silver solution directly into the bloodstream. See the Silver Lungs generator and lung delivery system at silverlungs.com. That's silverlungs.com.
On Free Talk Live, we're bringing people to the ideas of liberty every day. From wrestling superstars like Glenn Jacobs.
You guys really are having an impact, I believe. Like I said, a lot of where I am now is due to listening to Free Talk Live. You changed my mind on some very important issues years ago.
To random people tuning in on the radio.
I was kind of stuck in the left-right paradigm. I heard your show by chance on a Saturday night. From there, I went on, joined the Free State Project and become an amplifier. So, I mean, that's really the reason why I amp is because I know that if it wasn't for you guys being on as many stations as you are, I never would have found the ideas of liberty.
Your amp will directly change more lives by getting Free Talk Live in front of people looking for talk radio online and on the air. You can help by joining the AMP program for just $5 a month at amp.freetalklive.com and getting perks. That's amp.freetalklive.com.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
Ross Ulbricht was convicted in early 2015 of running the infamous Silk Road Underground Market.
The Silk Road was a gift to humanity and helped reduce the harms brought on by drug prohibition. For this good deed, Ross has been sentenced to life in prison with no possibility of parole. Now, an appeal is Ross's only chance, and he needs your support. Please visit FreeRoss.org, where you can contribute via various methods, including Bitcoin. Visit FreeRoss.org. That's FreeRoss.org.
Help get LRN.FM into more ears. Visit promote.lrn.fm for a free bumper sticker, flyers, banners, graphics, and more. Promote.lrn.fm.
It's Free Talk Live. You can join us on the radio at 855-450-FREE. To government overspending, to Bitcoin, whatever it is that is on your mind goes, you may join us here. Again, 855-450-FREE, and you can join us in real life at the upcoming Keenvention. Keenvention's happening October 30th through November 1st, and it's going to be another opportunity for you to come up to New Hampshire. There's some great ones throughout the year. There's the Liberty Forum that happens in the wintertime, which is thrown by the Free State Project. Of course, many of you listening, if you're listening for the first time, may not know what the Free State Project is. The idea is to concentrate libertarian types like Mark and myself into one geographic area. And the Free State Project has been doing encouraging people to move to New Hampshire for over a decade now, as a matter of fact. And their events that they throw
pretty successfully.
Yeah, their events are fantastic. They throw the Liberty Forum in the wintertime. They throw Pork Fest, the Porcupine Freedom Festival, in the summertime. But there's no Free State Project official event in the fall. And the Keenvention is not a Free State Project official event, but it is an event run by Free State Project participants. And I'm one of them. And I have the honor of putting the event together over the last 3 years. And it's a small event. It's probably the smallest of all of the various Liberty events in New Hampshire. It's very intimate, and so on the negative side is it really doesn't make any money. But on the positive side is it's fun. It's cool to get together with people in a small room and a relatively small amount of people. You know, just a few dozen people in a room at any given time, with maybe like a maximum of 100 or so over the entire weekend. That's about what the last couple of years have been. That's the way this year is working out. So that means there are plenty of tickets available if you want to get yours. They're $60 for the entire weekend. That gets you in for all of the speakers, the 11 panel discussions we're going to have covering everything from the legislative process this year. By the way, the legislative panel, it's finally been, I haven't announced it fully yet, but I've got all the names as far as who's going to be on the legislative panel. This is going to be an all-star legislative panel year. The legislator of the year from the New Hampshire Liberty Alliance, Dan Itza, will be on the panel this year.
I like him very much.
The rest of the panel will include, we've got four total A-plus state representatives on the panel this year, plus one A-rated rep. So our lowest rated rep on the panel is an A-rated representative by the New Hampshire Liberty Alliance. So.
You know, you won't know what your state's Liberty Alliance rating is because your state doesn't have one.
You don't have that.
Right. Yeah. You've got Democrats and Republicans, and yes, they rate each other, but these people don't know anything about human freedom. They don't know anything about free markets. They don't know anything about leaving you alone and not spending money.
It's not just legislative action, though. There's going to be our own Darrell W. Perry heading up his own political action panel talking about doing things outside of the two-party system. We've got non-political stuff like the cop block panel, people coming to the new movers in the old school panel, getting perspectives on what it's like to have just arrived in New Hampshire as part of the Free State Project, and the new movers panel, and the old school is people who've been here for a long time. In fact, I even brought in Dennis Goddard, longtime caller of our show, to host the old school panel. He's one of my critics, so you know I'm bringing my critic on stage to host a panel, which is great. And that's the kind of stuff that happens at Keenvention. Plus, lots of social events and activities like the bonfire is coming back for this year, which is going to be a lot of fun. Unfortunately, Mark, you're going to be out of town for Friday nights, so you're gonna miss that one. But go to keenvention.info because you can be here for it, and it's a unique event. Keenvention.info. You can get your tickets for Bitcoin, by the way, as well as $60 worth on your credit card. Keenvention.info. Let's go to Steve in Missouri. You're on Free Talk Live with Ian and Mark. Hello, Steve.
Hello.
Hey there.
So you guys were talking about copyright and last couple nights, of course, and yeah, as far as in the music industry, I was going to mention that there's an example, like with the Grateful Dead. Okay, so they've already caught on to this, and this was back in the late 60s, you know, early 70s. They already knew. You know,
are you referring to the fact that they would allow people to make bootlegs of their concerts and they encouraged that?
Yeah, they make bootlegs. They made areas for tapers to, you know, set up their microphones and make really high quality bootlegs. And they did that. Like, they made that possible.
And that was good for them because it helped their popularity, right? Like, if people can make bootlegs and spread their
music. Turns out if somebody hears your music, they're more likely to like your music.
And want to go to a concert or buy a copy.
Yeah, it's the concerts. And that's what it comes down to now, the way the music industry is changing. Really, that's where you have to make your money is actual live concerts. Yeah.
And so, T-shirts and other sort of concert-related sales of product, for instance.
I mean, I'm wearing a Grateful Dead T-shirt right now.
Thanks, Steve, for your call tonight.
Show that I paid for.
I appreciate it. I appreciate hearing from you. That's a great point. You know, talking about copyright, which we were discussing recently, and it's sort of we get into intellectual property pretty deep sometimes here on Free Talk Live because it's important. It's an important issue to us. We've based our show differently than a lot of shows do. I'll give you an example of. An interaction I actually had with one of our stations, WGMD in Maryland. The program director actually reached out to me, and I don't know why, but he asked me what I thought about a situation. I appreciate that he did. Sort of a legal situation that had cropped up there in town. There, and I don't know what the issue was, but there was some kind of blog in town that referenced the radio station. And
I pulled up
the email here from the program director, Walt. He says, a local blogger wrote about a broadcast presented about a month ago. The author included several sound bites that he recorded from our air. And then he's upset. He's upset about this because it included his licensed bumper music, his liners, which he paid a lot of money for, and his program material, all unauthorized use. And he doesn't credit the station as the source of the audio, so he doesn't even mention their call letters, WGMD. And so obviously he's upset about this. And in the world of intellectual property, when people use their property without their permission, they get upset about it. These creators do. But my response to him was. Essentially, that this is likely fair use, what this blogger was doing. You know, he's commenting on what was on the radio. Now, he didn't cite his source properly, which I don't know if that can get you in trouble or not. But
he's not a real journalist to know this. But I think that if the station owner got a hold of him, the guy should just go ahead and capitulate and put up some call letters, and that would make everybody happy.
I just told him my response was better to ignore the guy than to sue him because suing's only going to cost you money. You may not win anyway because it might, you know, the judge might kick it out and say, look, this is fair use. This guy's a political commentator. He can absolutely use your on-air feed just to, you know, comment on it for people. And so then what have you done? You've spent a bunch of time and effort and money going after he uses the term two-bit blogger here. Like, this guy's a nobody, right? You've then given him publicity.
Oh, yeah.
Because when you file a lawsuit.
He then gets, he's then legitimate, right?
Right. Now he's going to get a news story written
about
him.
He's as good as the people he attacks, right?
Yeah. So better to just leave it alone and focus your time on doing the things that you do best. And radio people don't sue best. They do radio best. You know, so you put your time into making your product.
Plus, what's the lawyer cost to do the suing?
That's what I'm saying. You're putting your time and your money into spinning your wheels, basically, in the court system in the hopes that you'll, teach this guy a lesson or something like that? Forget about him. Just, you know, focus in on doing the best radio you possibly can. And they do great radio, WGMD. They have Free Talk Live on the air. Thank you for that. but, you know, you focus your time on your product and your service. Don't get distracted by trying to control the actions of others. It's a waste. It really is. Let's continue here. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. We got
the blogger
John.
Should have still credited him.
The blogger absolutely should have done that. That's very poor form on his part, but no need to reward him with free publicity.
The internet's full of people in poor form. Yeah.
Just ignore him. John, you're on Free Talk Live with Ian and Mark.
Yeah, guys. I hope this isn't too touchy of a subject in the same vein, but the ad council kind of creeps me out because they're like government messages. They're always trying to get me to go to the forest and all sorts of other funded things. And I don't know the stations you guys are on, if there's some sort of conflict of interest where you can't speak against them because they pay the bills of the station from
the government. Can talk against the ad council. That's no problem.
So the
Are you hearing ad council ads during Free Talk Live there in Iowa?
Well, I don't know about during Free Talk Live, but it is on this station, and I just it's like it's the beginning of brainwashing to me. I can see
they're awful. They're just awful.
Well, they're well produced. But they often get aired too often.
But it is awful. I mean, it is brainwashing. It's government propaganda through and through, these ad council spots. Many of them are.
Where is it going to go? As this has been around for a long time, I think it goes back to the 70s from what I read on Wikipedia. I hope I've got that right. And I'm just wondering how much, you know, money is – how are stations required?
Stations are not getting paid generally for those ad council ads.
No, those are what they call fill ads. But stations are required to provide a public service component. And these ads...
Does that meet that component?
These ads will meet that component.
Really?
To some extent. I don't know. That's why they're out there. And they're well produced and they're given right to them. What I would recommend in this is the thing.
Hold that thought, Mark. Let's talk more about the ad council. If you want to stand by, you're welcome to as well, John. This is Free Talk Live, 855-450-FREE.
If you expect secure, privacy-oriented services and real human support from your web hosting provider, choose Virtual Space International. From domain names and SSL certificates to offshore banking accounts, Virtual Space International has been the all-in-one, multi-language solution for over 25 years. And satisfaction is guaranteed or your money back. We even accept Bitcoin. Find out how to get 50% off for life at SaveTimeHosting.com.
Are you searching for your soulmate? Someone you can trust, who will never betray you or cooperate with the NSA? Stop searching. With EasyDNS, you found a keeper. EasyDNS does it all. Domain names, web hosting, and managed WordPress hosting. EasyDNS stands up for your internet freedom. And with servers in Canada, they do not cooperate with the NSA. Go to EasyDNS.com. You'll love their services or get a full refund. They guarantee it. And they accept Bitcoin. That's EasyDNS.com.
If worst comes to worst, will you be prepared? You don't have to be a survivalist to prepare for the unexpected. Storing necessary supplies like food, water, and emergency equipment is simply taking responsibility for ourselves and our families when it counts the most. StrategicShelters.com offers emergency supplies and a secure way to store them, and provides protection for loved ones in the event of an extreme natural or man-made disaster. To find out more, visit StrategicShelters.com.
If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number three is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Darryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Saturday, September 26th, 2015. Silver is trading at $15.12 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,146 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $237. Antiwar.com reports, speaking Thursday to the Senate Intelligence Committee, NSA Chief Admiral Michael Rogers claimed that a potential government shutdown was a threat to national security on the grounds that the NSA might lose employees to the private sector if that happens. Rogers claims that NSA employees are so great that they could easily get much better jobs outside of the NSA, and that many are likely to do so if they believe the shutdown is going to threaten their pay, meaning the agency could lose significant numbers of workers. At the core, Rogers' complaint largely echoes some of the government agency chiefs who are opposed to the shutdown because they don't want to see their agency's funding threatened, or worse yet, see them shut down for a period of time long enough that the public realizes that what they're doing isn't really missed when it's gone. That's the real threat to the NSA, in particular, with so much of their activity done entirely in secret, and the public only having the government's word for it that what the NSA is doing is actually important. The question could quickly be brought to the fore with a shutdown, and particularly with all the objectionable things the NSA is known to do, their value is already a subject of debate.
For over 35 years, Roberts & Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co.
UPI reports Texas correction officials on Friday admitted that they have supplied doses of a lethal drug to the state of Virginia for an execution there, but refused to disclose how they obtained the chemical. Officials said three vials of the drug pentobarbital were given to the Virginia Department of Corrections. Pentobarbital is a barbiturate often used in lethal injections that can cause death in high doses. On Friday, the Texas Department of Criminal Justice acknowledged that it shared the drug with Virginia, but refused to disclose where they had obtained the pentobarbital. Virginia is scheduled to execute an inmate next week, its first in 2 years. The Texas Department of Criminal Justice said state law prohibits the agency from disclosing the identity of the supplier of lethal injection drugs. Friday's disclosure came a day after attorneys for Oklahoma death row inmate Richard Glossop filed court papers claiming the Texas government is now manufacturing its own lethal injection drugs and it is sharing them with Virginia. Glossop is scheduled to be executed on September 30th, barring a last-minute reprieve. Oklahoma will use the drug midazolam to aid in his execution, but Glossop has requested pentobarbital, which is considered to be more reliable in executions since it appears that Texas is able to supply the drug.
You can support FPP Radio by joining the Fans program. Fans are friends, allies, and Numeri supporters. Fans help FPP afford to produce more original content. You can join the Fans program for as little as $3 per month or any amount of Bitcoin per month, thanks to the recurring payment options provided by Coinbase. To learn more or to join the Fans program, visit fans.fppradio.com. That's fans.fppradio.com.
Reuters reports House Speaker John Boehner will leave Congress at the end of October after struggling with repeated rebellions by conservatives during a tumultuous 5-year reign as the chamber's top Republican. The 65-year-old congressman from Ohio stunned Republican House members at a meeting on Friday morning with the announcement that he would resign his seat effective October 30th. U.S. Representative Kevin McCarthy of California, the number 2 House Republican, quickly became the leading contender to replace Boehner as Speaker. While loyal to Boehner, McCarthy has built personal relationships with conservative groups and tacked right recently to back the shutdown of the Export-Import Bank. Boehner has faced constant pressure from conservatives who believe he was too willing to compromise with President Obama and too frequently relied on Democratic votes to pass crucial legislation. Boehner told reporters he was stepping aside to avoid another brewing House battle over his leadership. Conservatives had threatened a revolt and possible government shutdown over spending next week. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
A new Gallup poll found that the GOP has an overwhelming advantage among young people who look like old men. The poll shows Republicans hold a solid lead among the coveted elderly youth demographic, including 18 to 24-year-olds who wear suspenders and bow ties to class every day. I'm joined by Republican strategist Rob Powell. These are pretty encouraging numbers for the GOP, aren't they?
Yeah, of course, it's very encouraging. Millennials who look like they're permanently dressed for boat trips are a rapidly growing segment of the population.
And according to the survey, the prematurely aged are also very politically active.
Absolutely. Only about 20% of young people vote overall, but there's almost 100% turnout among youth that dress like a dad from a 1950 sitcom.
Now, what about the criticism that the GOP only appeals to white men?
Not true. We also have a lot of support among sorority girls that wear pantsuits and pearls, paunchy Chinese college students, and we're making inroads among African-American ham radio enthusiasts.
This is the Onion News Network.
Free Talk Live.
It's Free Talk Live, and you can join us here on the air. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. And with you tonight, it's Ian.
And Mark.
And we have on this show, over the history of Free Talk Live, we've been doing the show since 2002, so it's been a while. Every now and then we'll delve into kind of the inner workings of the business, which you're not supposed to do in radio because, you know, it's show business and you're putting on a show and, you know, it's glamorous here in the radio world. But it's not. It's not really not that glamorous.
Not glamorous.
A lot of the times I'm sitting in here in my boxer shorts. Not tonight, though, because it's a little cold.
Yeah, you don't do that much anymore. Thank God.
I actually have done it, but it's a little too chilly for it right now here in New Hampshire. And so, no, it is not a glamorous business. We're talking about sort of the internals, the behind the scenes. John called in. He's still with us listening in Ames, Iowa. You were calling to complain about the government propaganda, a.k.a. the Ad Council commercials that you hear so frequently on talk radio and elsewhere, right?
Yes. Yes. And I really appreciate you guys talking about the inner workings of radio. I mean, if public service announcements are like a percentage of required time for a private business like a radio station, you know, like if it's a tornado or a flood's on the way, or, you know, everybody needs a duck and cover or something, then I can understand that to an extent. But it also kind of creeps me a little out a little bit. I'm wondering if I'd really like to hear you guys, and this is touchy maybe, talk about how would the government kind of squeeze in and start to plan. If there was like long range planning to just shut up conservative and libertarian radio, how would, you know, I mean, they must hate you guys. I mean,
some people, do.
A big government or liberals must, I know they despise conservative radio and libertarian radio. So what would be like a long-term plan that we could like, notice, like,
I'll give it to you.
Have like a keyword you could tell us, you know, they're at the gates here, they're at the station, they're going to shut it down.
I don't think it has to go that way.
How would that evolve? How would they squeeze you guys out and shut you up?
Good question.
So first off, to say that Republican radio is effective ignores Obama's election, both of them. It ignores a great deal. Like Rush Limbaugh made his chops off of complaining about the Clinton administration.
Oh, thank you for the call.
Al Gore couldn't take one of the most successful presidencies of my lifetime and turn it into another run. I mean, I just don't think that Republican radio is that effective. Generally, it's a lot of the choir listening to each other. So,
well, yeah, but they want to paint a picture of them being effective, right?
Yeah, like, sure, you know, sure.
Rush Limbaugh would like you to believe that his show is having some sort of a huge, tremendous impact.
He and Howard Stern made Snapple what they were, but that, you know, you need a much smaller percentage. You're talking about half the voting population needs to agree with you, and that isn't necessarily it. So what are they going to do? They're doing it. The FCC currently is the chairman is decided by the Obama administration. I can't remember his name off the top of my
Tom
head.
Tom Wheeler.
And he has stopped the opportunity for AM stations to get FM translators.
Yeah, that's
so the
true.
FM, basically talk radio is on the AM dial.
Yeah.
And this is a way to sort of save AM. AM was in bad shape.
It's still in bad
when
shape.
Rush came along, and it's still in bad shape. But what's happening is many AMs across the United States are getting FM translators. They can broadcast on the FM dial. Wherever you are, if you're listening to me, the chances are good there's open dial position where you are. Not every place in the United States, but most places geographically in the United States have plenty of open space in the dial. So those AMs can then use that FM dial space to broadcast their content. And then they're on the FM dial too, like everybody else is listening. So you can cruise through and hit the scan button and find them. And that's going to be what allows AM to come back. And the Democrats essentially aren't going to allow that because Democratic talk radio is a much smaller than Republican talk radio.
But they're also on AM as well. A lot of those
They are.
Lefty stations are
but
on
they
AM.
But the Democrats can't convince their Democratic politicians to do something nice for them because the politician says to himself, if I kill AM radio, 90% of who I'm killing. My attrition rate is one Democrat for every 10 Republicans.
But
I'll take that number.
But wait, look, I know that there have been headlines in the industry recently about these FM translators that you're talking about, Mark. But isn't it the case that they're just not giving preference to the AM operators? Like, you can still try to get a translator. You
can apply
for it.
They can try to do that, but there should be a window open right now. They should be opening a window. In 2016, any AM operator, you know, should be able to put in an application for an FM translator. Whammo, bammo, we're going to give that to you because we care about providing local content, local live content to people.
But most of it's not local and live. A lot of it is syndicated off the bird.
Well, it's local. It's being broadcast locally.
Yeah, that's not local, though. You and I both know that, right? Like, Free Talk Live, we're
make
in Keene, New Hampshire. We're not going to try to pull the wool over your eyes and pretend like we're in your town.
No,
I mean, I know the station would like us to do that.
We never do that, but... make it a criteria. Say, hey, during this AM window, you have to provide 3 hours a day of live, of local content. Your music station sure isn't local either. The music's coming out of Los Angeles, New York, and Nashville. And then the people who are doing the talking in between, in many cases, aren't even in your market at all.
So that's truer more so than not.
Plus the fact that music is boring. You're listening to Total Eclipse of the Heart again, or Crazy Train, or Friends in Low Places. You're just hearing the same content over and over
Play
again.
Play some Skinner.
Right. I mean, you know what? I like these songs. That's fine by me.
I played them when I was in rock radio.
But I just, when I turn on the car radio, what I don't want to hear is the same crap over and over again. It's just the same
songs.
Well,
you get that out of conservative talk radio anyway.
At the very least,
the talk show hosts are all doing what Rush is doing.
They're saying it differently.
Well, barely.
NPR is actually repeating the same programs.
Is that right?
So talk radio provides you with the most unique content that is out there at any given time.
That's true. Look, I'm not trying to down talk radio stations. It's, you know, running syndicated talk is sort of just the nature of the business these days. It's hard.
It's very, very difficult to make money since Rush Limbaugh called that Sandra Fluke gal the S word, you know. Business has been a little difficult. It's picking up this year. You can take a look at the numbers and see how it's going. But many talk stations have decided to try sports, as though being the third sports station in a given market is going to somehow make them money. Or they'll try – by sports, I mean sports talk. Usually they don't actually broadcast the sports. They just talk about the sports.
Let's go to the phones to the fun. Severin listening in Pennsylvania. You're on Free Talk Live with Ian and Mark. Hello. Severin.
Hey, what's going on, guys?
Welcome. You're on the radio. Go ahead.
Not much. I just wanted to call in and talk on some points about government and some things that happened in my town this past week
that I thought would
be interesting. Have you heard about the House bill that's being nicknamed the Thin Blue Line bill?
No, is this a Pennsylvania thing?
No, it's actually going through in Pennsylvania. There's a few senators here that are pushing it through, but it's going to be a national bill once it goes through.
Okay.
How would it go through the Pennsylvania House and be a national bill? I don't understand.
Because they're pushing it through the Pennsylvania, and it's going to become a national policy once it if it becomes policy in Pennsylvania.
Washington, D.C.?
Exactly.
And it's called the Thin Blue Line Bill, you said?
Sounds horrifying already. Yeah. Go ahead.
Okay. So what this bill is calling for is harsher punishments for people who target police officers, people who target any government employees, but mainly it's going around police officers.
It's a hate crime bill to protect cops.
Right. But what's not being discussed, what I really think that people need to realize is the hidden language in this bill and what it is going to be called, what is actually going to look like in practice. It's not going to be persecuting people. It's going to be protecting cops. It's going to no longer allow the media to run the cops' names when they're involved.
I want to hear more about it. Stand by, Severin. A thin blue line. Now, for those who don't know, the thin blue line is code for basically their gang symbol. The police have a gang symbol. You can see it sometimes on their personal cars. It's a little black bumper sticker, little like square sticker with a blue line running through it. It's Free Talk Live. We'll tell you more. You can take control of the airwaves.
Has this ever happened to you? You're applying for some type of a loan. whether online or in person, when it's time to hit submit, your nerves spike because you're not sure you'll get the approval you seek. There's a different way to approach life. It's called Credit Success Secrets Revealed. Credit Success Secrets Revealed is a revolutionized step-by-step system that you can follow to get all the credit you desire today. We're talking about secured and unsecured credit, car leases, credit cards, and cash. Call 800-568-8960. Credit Success Secrets Revealed works no matter what your current situation, whether you've had bad credit, never had credit, or looking for some business credit or any type of credit. Please call 800-568-8960. We don't take any personal information. Your personal information is way too valuable to trust to a third-party email or a website that doesn't answer the phone. At Credit Success Secrets Revealed, we show you step-by-step what to place into the financial computer systems that control your credibility in the marketplace today. We practically fill out the forms for you.
Credit Success Secrets Revealed works 100% of the time. Call now, 800-568-8960. That's 800-568-8960, 800-568-8960.
Does being over 40 make you feel like half the man you used to be? Do you feel more tired, out of shape, not in the mood like you used to be? Thanks to an exclusive formula, you can help boost testosterone levels safely and naturally. Introducing Ageless Male, a life-changing supplement for men tested to help increase testosterone levels.
You'll notice a boost in your energy levels, workouts work, sex life improves. It's like a light switch goes on.
Try Ageless Male risk-free if you would like to experience what taking Ageless Male can feel like. Support for healthy, normal testosterone levels, healthy energy, and increased performance, and more romance when you want it.
Call 1-800-327-4821. That's 1-800-327-4821. 800-327-4821. 800-327-4821. That's 1-800-327-4821.
Every once in a while, you get information that's worth changing your life for. This is one such time. You can save up to and beyond 25% on all purchases at Amazon. You probably heard of Bitcoin and just not thought much about it. You certainly know that you can get competitive pricing at Amazon, but now you can get a 25% discount on nearly everything you need to live. I've just given you a huge raise, and all you have to do is claim it. You go to saveitpurse.com and open an account. Do this right now. Don't wait. Then you fund the account with Bitcoin. You can buy them through expresscoin.com with a check or money order. There are other ways to get Bitcoin, but that's fast, safe, and easy. This information is worth you changing the way you do things. Go to saveitpurse.com right now, get signed up, and cash in on the huge raise I'm offering you. 15 to 25% off of everything at Amazon through saveitpurse.com. It's saveatpurse.com. Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats and the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's posts pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. Facebook.freetalklive.com.
So you've signed the Shire Society Declaration and are planning your move to New Hampshire to be around more liberty-oriented people. Next, sign up for the Shire Society Forum at forum.shiresociety.com. There are a bunch of people there who are already in the Shire, and they want to meet you. If you're already in the Shire physically, you should also come by the forums. Remember, not everyone uses Facebook. New people are signing up for the Shire Society Forum every month, so drop in and say hello at forum.shiresociety.com.
This is the Liberty Radio Network, broadcasting the latest liberty-oriented audio content 24 hours a day at LRN.fm.
It's Free Talk Live. Join us on the radio waves, 855-450-FREE. 855-450-3733, and you can join us online at freetalklive.com. We've got Skype. Skype on in here at username LRN.FM. And you can, of course, support the show in a variety of different ways. One of them is by becoming a Free Talk Live amplifier at amp.freetalklive.com. AMP stands for Advertise, Market, and Promote. If you like the show and you enjoy what we're doing here on Free Talk Live, talking about the ideas of liberty 7 nights a week,
And if you don't get us all 7 nights on your local station, you can always call your station and talk to the program director and ask real nicely to get more Free Talk Live. But we're here doing the show 7 nights a week. And if you like that, then help us out. $5 a month gets you access to special bonuses like the AMP-only podcast. There are the AMP-only phone lines as well as the AMP-only Facebook group.
Now, the AMP-only podcast is commercial-free for people that are concerned with that.
Yep, that's correct. And the Facebook group's great. It's super busy. It's like probably one of the busiest groups I'm on Facebook. Great interactions between Free Talk Live listeners, co-hosts, and things like that. So go and check it out.
To some extent, it's like the board of directors for Free Talk Live. We float a lot of ideas about the show past the amplifiers.
Yeah, aren't you floating some t-shirt designs past them right now?
T-shirt designs right now that we're actually, you can see at cam.freetalklive.com.
That's right.
And folks are, you know, they're excited about it there.
Make sure you can actually see that on the cam. Yes, you can see it. All right, so yeah, cam.freetalklive.com.
I got a t-shirt on that has the Free Talk Live logo and it says taxes are theft on them.
I think our listeners are going to love it.
Yeah.
So those aren't yet available, but if you're in the AMP group on Facebook, you can see the pictures and stuff.
You'll know
like that.
First.
Yeah, you'll know first. So go and become an amplifier at amp.freetalklive.com, ampamp.freetalklive.com. Any major credit card is accepted through PayPal or Visa or MasterCard right there on the front page at amp.freetalklive.com. Back with Severin. He's in Pennsylvania, and you said there's a thin blue line proposed law, a bill that has been thrown out there to ostensibly protect the police by increasing penalties for people who attack them or whatever. But other things are outrageous in this bill. It's not just about hate crimes. It's more than that. And you had just scratched the surface on it. So tell me more.
Yeah, so what's basically going to be happening, if you read through the bill and you look at the way that this is worded, is it's putting another layer of protection on police. No longer do police need to protect police. Now, the entire media needs to cover for a cop who's involved in an incident until that cop is convicted. So basically, the cop gets to be investigated by his own people, and as we all seen numerous times, when he's cleared of these charges, no one will ever hear who the cop was that shot the man on the corner.
So just to be clear on something here, you're saying this thin blue line law proposes that members of the media cannot reveal which cop is being accused of doing something naughty?
It's not even the, it's not, it doesn't go as far as the members of the media. It's not even going to get to the media. The way that it works now is a department is required to release the information to the public of what happened. Now the department is literally putting up a barrier that they do not need to release the information anymore. If this bill goes into place,
wow,
there will quite literally be no more accountability for cops. The public will not know.
Well, police are a protected class, and you know, many times they'll act as though they are, you know, in some ways being set upon or whatever. But they enjoy qualified immunity as part of their job. It gives them immunity from their actions inside of a work situation, and that, you know, that in of itself shows that they are not a beset upon class, but they actually have more strength. The cops generally get what they want when it comes to the legislative process because, well, the politicians want to make them happy. So they do. They get what they want. And this is going to be another circumstance. I wouldn't be surprised at all.
It's outrageous. I mean, this is just it flies in the face of freedom of the press, freedom of information, the right to transparency of government. Now, I know this is Pennsylvania, so I don't know what the rules are there, but here in New Hampshire, Article 8 in the New Hampshire Constitution specifies that New Hampshire or that the government here is supposed to be open and accountable. And this would fly right in the face of
that. The constitutions were written by people that's paid far more attention to their governments in times when they trusted them far less. These days, Americans just don't seem to care. It's like, it's the cop's job, whatever.
What is the what's the public response? You know, has talk radio been talking about this, or is this just something that like police accountability people know about and no one else?
You know, this has been really quietly done. I'm actually the head of Lehigh Valley Cop Block. I'm active in my community every day, and this managed to slip by me.
Wow,
this that's
was
quiet.
Quietly done.
So this hasn't passed. It's just quietly. A bill, right? It's being proposed. It hasn't yet passed the state legislature.
It is something that the senator, the governor, and they had a couple police chiefs talking about this in my local town, and it wasn't even publicized to any outside media organizations that weren't in their pockets, basically.
This sounds outrageous. Keep us in the loop, Severin. I'm sorry to hear the news about that. And I do want to
let you know the good side of what we are doing.
Okay. Yeah, please.
Since we found out about this, we have hit the street. We have let people know about this. We even invited some friends of Keene up here. We got J.P. Freeman in town right now.
Oh, that's right.
We got a huge festival in town with tens of thousands of people that we went out all day today and hit and confronted the police about this bill, confronted the public that was supporting the police. I stood back and watched J.P. work his magic with a couple cops that were just totally, totally acting like that they were in charge of things. And it was we did a great outreach today.
Well,
it was really powerful, and we're going to continue to do it. We're going to continue to hit the streets and make sure that the public knows exactly what is going to be.
Well, whether the public knows, I don't know if that's going to have any effect on what the politicians decide to do, but it can't hurt to get the word out. At the very least, you'll certainly get the word out about copblock.org and your local chapter there. And Severin, thanks for the call tonight, and have fun out there with the Keeniacs that came down to visit during this time. Thanks, Severin, for the call tonight. Of course, as we talked to Adamo Freeman last night on the show, the founder of copblock.org, which is the world's premier cop police accountability website.
It was essentially launched here on the air on Free Talk Live.
I don't know if it was launched on the air, but it was certainly launched.
Did it get any press before that?
The founders did live here in Keene, and they've both been behind microphones on Free Talk Live.
At the time of the launching of it?
And we did
talking
sponsor,
about it and promoting it?
We did sponsor their tours and such way back in the day, and we're back on, by the way, Mark, I don't know if you've seen the pictures yet, but the Mobile Accountability for Cops RV, Mac,
yeah.
The new RV. The Free Talk Live LRN Free Keene logos are up there just like old times. So we're once again sponsoring the tour, along with Cell 411, by the way, which is a really cool app for people who are doing cop block and others who are just maybe if you're in a neighborhood watch group. Cell 411 is a great app. It's 99 cents. It allows you to send out alerts to your buddies, your friends, your family members, letting them know what's happening to you. You have a breakdown on the highway? Send a Cell 411 out. You got the cops harassing you? Send out a Cell 411. Having a medical emergency? Cell 411 can help bring people around. It's a really cool tool, and so I'm glad to see that Cell 411 is behind the Mobile Accountability for Cops tour. It's going on right now. Copblock.org/Mac, M-A-C. Copblock.org/Mac to learn more about it, and we'll keep you in the loop. This is Free Talk Live. You can join us at 855-450-FREE.
Hi, I'm Dr. Sam Nussbaum with the Anthem Foundation. Premature birth is the leading cause of death of babies and disabilities for children. That's why we support the March of Dimes to help mothers have full-term pregnancies and healthy babies. Join us in supporting cutting-edge research, treatment and outreach to help moms during their pregnancy and give every baby a healthy start in life. Learn how you can help at marchofdimes.org.
This is Dan Pilla. Do you owe the IRS money you can't pay? Are tax debts crippling you? I've defended people from the IRS for over 30 years. I've helped thousands, and I can help you too. I wrote the book on IRS settlement, and I'm telling you, there's no such thing as a hopeless case. Call 800-34-NO-TAX to finally get free of IRS debt. With the IRS's new programs, there's never been a better time to solve your problem. Call 800-34-NO-TAX. That's 800-34-NO-TAX or my website, danpilla.com.
Money, power, and respect are all yours at CreditSuccessSecretsRevealed.com. Be seen as an industry leader. You can do it. The last application you filled out when it was time to hit submit, did your nerves spike? You didn't get the approval you seek, but there's a better way. We teach you exactly what to place into the right systems the right way the first time so you get approved. Get up to $100,000 in instant business credit. Many people will get cash on the spot. Use those two tools in your new corporate credit engine so you can walk into the bank and get your project funded today. It's all about today at CreditSuccessSecretsRevealed.com. Credit Success Secrets Revealed is explosive and ignites instant results. Dial 1-800-707-8719. That's 1-800-707-8719. 1-800-707-8719. Or just go to CreditSuccessSecretsRevealed.com.
bitcoin.com.
If you want to play online poker with Bitcoin, you need a site that's trustworthy and technically sound. The site managers of swcpoker.eu have proven their commitment to bringing you great gameplay from a site you can trust, swcpoker.eu. They have lots of new games too, including Chinese poker, and their Krill leaderboard is open right now. It's a beautiful site, easy to use with lots of players. Go on over to swcpoker.eu now and have some fun with your Bitcoin. swcpoker.eu. So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at LRN.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at LRN.fm. That's LRN.fm.
Understanding your credit score is the first step towards managing and improving it. This is Charlie Sundstrom with your Van Dyke Mortgage Minute. The most influential component of your credit score is your payment history. Almost equally as important is the amount you owe on credit accounts. Also impacting your score, but to a lesser degree, are the length of time you've utilized your credit, the number of new accounts, credit inquiries, and your various types of credit accounts. To help achieve or maintain a healthy credit score, have a system set up to assure your bills are always paid on time. Don't max out your cards. It's better to have a high credit limit with a low balance. Never close old accounts. The age of these can actually help your credit score. But don't be afraid to use your credit. You need several accounts in order to have a credit score. Just keep the corresponding payments within your means. For your mortgage pre-approval and refi needs, start by visiting VanDykeMortgage.com.
Corporate NMLS 3035. Van Dyke Mortgage is an equal housing lender. Charlie Sundstrom, NMLS 134251.
You can sign up to receive the latest about the Liberty Radio Network via our email updates at updates.lrn.fm. That's updates.lrn.fm.
Yes, it is Free Talk Live, and you can join us here just by dialing toll-free on this live Saturday edition. Our number, 855-450-FREE, that's 855-450-3733. With you in studio tonight, you've got me, Ian.
And me, Mark.
And Free Talk Live brought to you by Victimless Crime Spree. It is a great documentary film that just celebrated its third anniversary of its theatrical release just a couple of weeks ago, and you can go watch it for free. Over at victimlesscrimespree.com, it's our friend Derek J, who has who was arrested 5 times in a 1-year time frame. We got it all on video, and it makes for a really entertaining.
And nary a victim any of those times.
Never hurt anybody, and despite the fact that he's never hurt anyone, he was denied a concealed carry permit. So actually, the saga of Derek J's victimless crime spree continued this week. In fact, continued to this very day. When I'm going to break some news here, I think, because I don't think Derek has written the story up yet. Over at freekeen.com, but he did promise me that that he was going to do that. Yeah, he hasn't yet done so. So be on the lookout over at freekeen.com for Derek's version of this story, but he just got his Supreme Court verdict back.
Uh-huh.
He applied had applied for a concealed weapons permit here in, or license, I guess they call it, here in New Hampshire. So in New Hampshire, you're allowed to legally open carry a gun, no problem. As long as you're not a felon, it's no problem at all. Pretty much anywhere. You can't go into a school with it, but otherwise, you know, pretty much anywhere except unless businesses don't want you to be there with a gun, you can conceal, you can open carry. I'm sorry, open carry. So he applied for a concealed carry license, was denied, which is supposed to be, this is supposed to be a shall issue state. That's the terminology, shall issue.
Let me read the second 2A, the right of bearing arms. All persons have the right to keep and bear arms in defense of themselves, their family, their property, and the state.
This is the New Hampshire Constitution.
That's their, I mean, they're clear. It isn't the Second Amendment that's talking about the militia or anything like that. It doesn't say that.
Yeah.
It says all persons have the right to keep and bear arms in defense of themselves, their families, their property, and the state.
Unless you are deemed unsuitable by the government.
It doesn't say that, though.
Right, but that's what has happened. There's a statute that says that
it's extra constitutional to say, well, that statute doesn't pass constitutional muster.
Well, the Supreme Court decided they weren't going to look at the
Supreme Court can't read.
They decided that, no. They decided they weren't going to look at the constitutional question because it wasn't brought up during the initial trial. So therefore, they have the legal reason to not look at that question in this particular case. So what they did do was they upheld the lower court's decision that that agreed with the police chief that Derek J. is not a suitable person to have a concealed weapons permit. That doesn't stop him from bearing the arms, right? So if you think about it from their perspective, Mark, they're saying, hey, look, Derek J., you can still bear the arm. You just have to open carry it. So you can still have the gun. You could even have a machine gun and open carry that, right? Like, you can carry the baddest ass rifle you possibly could slung to your back in New Hampshire, and it would be completely legal for him to do that. But if he were to put a coat on that covers that gun up.
Or sit in his car.
Yeah, or, yeah, because there's ridiculous car rules. But anyway, the Supreme Court backed up the trial court's ruling.
I'm really kind of surprised.
Really? I'm surprised you're surprised about that. But yeah, so basically Derek J. is prohibited at this time from having a firearm concealed carry in New Hampshire, which is sort of a continuation of something that began all the way back when he was making his movie, Victimless Crime Spree. We've got the three-page court decision, relatively brief, three pages, scanned in. I sent it to Derek. As soon as he finishes the article, it'll be available for you to read over at freekeen.com. So we'll keep you in the loop as that story develops. Let's go to Scott, listening in Greenfield, Indiana, to WIBC-FM. Hello, Scott.
Hi again, Ian. I was a little bit taken aback taking at face value the words from that one guy, and then I was like, he sounds kind of like one of these guys I think he is. They said he was ahead of cop block in his area. I was like,
yeah,
okay, well, speaking of someone who's looked on the cop block site, my head about exploded after looking at it for about 20 minutes. It's just like, to me, the best I could tell from it seems to be run by a bunch of either anarchists or lawbreakers who are butthurt about having been arrested. And, you know,
what difference does it make? Hold on. Who the people are doesn't matter. That's what they call a logical fallacy. It doesn't matter who they are.
Credibility, yes, it does.
What's that?
Credibility.
Well, to me, someone who's been arrested has more credibility.
People actually celebrate cops getting shot.
I don't know. See, now that's a different thing. Like, they celebrate cops getting shot is an argument, whereas they are a bunch of anarchists is not an argument. Do you understand what I'm saying?
Well, if...
Hello? I think he might have gone into a bad cell. Yep. Scott, you're welcome to call back. We did not intend to hang up. His call just dropped. If there's a technical difficulty like that, normally it's a one call per night rule here on Free Talk Live, but if there's a problem, you can call back in. I want to hear more about what Scott has to say about cop block.
I also want to know what celebrating cops getting shot is. For instance, I've heard people say things like when a police officers go break into somebody's home for a drug raid, sometimes not even the right house, police officers get shot. Some people will say things like, if they hadn't have busted into the house, they wouldn't have been shot. That's not celebration of a cop being shot, but I've heard people say that. It's like, essentially, mm-hmm. You know, you're besmirching the good name of our police officers, and, you know, you just can't say things like that. Well, it's the truth. If police didn't make these raids, these 50,000 drug raids in this country every single year,
yep.
Then and left people alone in their homes, then, well, a handful of them, and... There's been this year the amount of police that have died, on duty that didn't have to do with sort of heart attacks or getting knocked into the ditch on the side of the road from a car or something like that. Police officers who died in sort of gunfights and things like that. The numbers are down. This war on cops is being prosecuted very poorly if it is occurring.
I'm on the front page of copblock.org right now. I don't see any headlines that are shouting out about celebrating or glorifying the killing of the police. Now, I'm not saying that there wouldn't have been someone working for Copblock at some point that has that viewpoint. I wouldn't say that for a moment.
There are some people that are very yes, absolutely. There are people that are very upset at law enforcement in this country, and they're liable to say a bunch of different things.
But as far as somebody getting arrested, Ademo Freeman, the founder of copblock.org, was arrested for selling marijuana in Wisconsin a few years back, several years ago. He went to jail for it for a period of time. And you know what?
that was the arrest that catalyzed him, that that sent him off into this realm of wanting to do something about the abuse of the police.
Well, the average person is never going to complain about the abuse from the police because the average person isn't dealing with it. It's people that have dealt with police that are going to be upset.
Right. Ademo's not a bad guy.
The policing organizations have been here all along. I mean, they have been able to form and shape their public relations up to this point. The fact is that video has entered into this realm in a way that has surprised police. You know, like this is new. They tried to fight it. They tried to bring up wiretapping laws. They tried to prosecute people at it. The courts have said again and again and again, no, you're a public servant on public property being paid public money, and what you do is the public's interest. Stop arresting people with cameras. And they continue to do it, by the way, showing that they're, you know, don't mind abusing a little power and that, frankly, the courts really won't do anything to them. So what if you levy a fine against the city I work for? Big deal.
Ademo's been arrested for recording the police, too, and he won that case.
Ademo's got a big settlement from some police that broke the law.
That's right.
And, you know, it just happens over and over again. Nobody calls in and says, you know what, I'm sick and tired of these police breaking the law and my tax money going to, you know, complain about. They call in and complain about a website that attempts to hold government bureaucrats responsible.
Right. And really, the complaint was about the people running the site. The complaint was about, oh, well, they're criminals. Okay, great.
Everybody's a criminal now. Well, right. It took you 600 years to read the laws in this country. You're a criminal if a cop decides you're one.
Look, the people who've been through the system have more credibility in my mind than some reporter. These are the guys who've been there. They've been on the inside of a jail cell. They've been in the handcuffs. They've been behind, you know, in the backseat of a cruiser. They know what this is like. They've been, some of them, been there more than once. And not for hurting anybody. Ademo's never been accused of violence against the police. He's never been accused of violence against another human being. He sold marijuana. It's a flower. He satisfied his customers. And he went to jail for it. And that's what set him off and made him want to create Cop Block. So there you go, cops. There's an unintended consequence of the war on drugs for you. You created Cop Block inadvertently by arresting Ademo Freeman, cops. How do you feel about that? 855-450-FREE. It's Free Talk Live.
For P150, P150GA, P150OK, P150TN, C250A, C250E, C250Q. Not available in all states.
What's the scariest thing about going to the dentist? Opening your mouth or opening your wallet? Because just a simple cleaning can cost $100, and things like root canals can cost you hundreds more. If you don't have dental insurance to help, call Physicians Mutual Insurance Company, 1-800-809-5580. This isn't a discount plan or preventive-only coverage. This is real dental insurance that helps pay for checkups right away, so you can call today and get your teeth cleaned tomorrow. Plus, it helps cover the more expensive procedures you might need down the road. Fillings, crowns, bridges, even costly dentures. There's no deductible and no annual maximum. Your acceptance is guaranteed for one of these insurance policies, even if you're retired. There are no networks, so you can choose any dentist you'd like. Call in the next 10 minutes and we'll rush you a free information kit with all the details. 1-800-809-5580. That's 1-800-809-5580. 1-800-809-5580.
Hunters, anglers, campers, and survivalists, get back to nature. Expand your horizons with the highest quality, most versatile, unique slingshots and slingbows on the market at slingbow.com. Slingbow products are compact and models start from just $17.98. They're perfect for your bug out bag or storing in your vehicle. Give yourself and your loved ones the excitement and tradition of slingbow, a new frontier in archery and truly modern twist on this primitive survival tool. Feel the thrill only at slingbow.com.
Hey, Berkey Guy here. Are you still drinking unfiltered tap water? Does your water contain chlorine or fluoride? Will you have drinkable water in an emergency? The Berkey Guy is here to help you remove these and other potential contaminants from your water, thus helping you drink clean, purified water. We offer Berkey water purification systems at the lowest available prices online. Don't go another moment without Berkey system. Over the last 10 years, we've helped thousands drink clean, purified water. Join them by visiting goberkey.com or call me, the Berkey Guy, at 877-886-3653. That's 877-886-3653.
Keenvention is coming up fast, October 30th through November 1st. Get your tickets now at keenvention.info. Keenvention is an intimate event where you can meet dozens of key liberty activists from across the Shire, including Oathkeeper Chris Reitman, Libertarian presidential candidate Daryl W. Perry, illegal Uber driver Christopher David, NeoCash Radio's Dr. Darren Tapp, State Representative Mike Sylvia, rated an A+ by the NHLA, the Seditious Sirens, the Rebel Love Show's Rob Mathias, tech guru Brian Sovereign,
Cop blocker J.P. Freeman, new mover Dr. Taryn Lupo, longtime political activist Dennis Goddard, Church of the Invisible Hand minister Rich Paul, Shire Dude, and dozens more. Only 100 tickets are available in advance, so lock yours in now for just $60 or with Bitcoin. That includes access to the Hallokeen costume dance party. Reserve your tickets now at keenvention.info. Visit keenvention.info for more speaker announcements, or look for our page and event on Facebook. That's keenvention.info.
LRN.fm is proud to announce our official listening apps for Android and iOS devices. Now you can easily tune into our streams anywhere, anytime on your smartphone or tablet. Just visit apps.lrn.fm or search for LRN.fm in the Android or Apple app stores. Please download, rate it 5 stars, then share the link on social media, and let your friends and family know how you're listening to LRN.fm. Download it now, free at apps.lrn.fm. That's apps.lrn.fm.
This is your Roberts & Roberts Brokerage Daily Precious Metals Update. In early trading Friday, gold is $6 lower at $1,147 per ounce. Silver is down 2 cents at $15.18 per ounce. Bitcoin is trading at $236. The prospect for getting ahead on silver American Eagles looks bad, but we have plenty of spiders, Britannias, and kangaroos in stock. Give us a call at 800-874-9760 or visit us online at rrbi.co.
What's up next? Visit the Liberty Radio Network program guide to find out at shows.lrn.fm. That's shows.lrn.fm.
It's Free Talk Live, live Saturday edition. Continuing here with you, it's Ian
and Mark.
Join us online at freetalklive.com. All the features are free, so please enjoy those. If you like what we're doing here on Free Talk Live, you can shop with us. Go to shop.freetalklive.com. We talk a lot about saveitpurse.com these days. For those of you who are willing to pay with Bitcoin, you get huge discounts at Amazon. But, you know, for whatever reason, you still don't want to do that, you can still go through our old Amazon shopping links, and those still work, and it gets us a nice cut of your Amazon on sale when you go to shop.freetalklive.com. So you're going to get your Amazon shopping done. You don't want to do the saveitpurse.com thing. You can still go to shop.freetalklive.com, and it helps us out when you do that. You still get the same great Amazon prices, the same super saver shipping and prime shipping deals. It's just that Free Talk Live gets a cut of Amazon's profits when you go through shop.freetalklive.com. So don't forget about that. It is still there. We just focus more on the save it purse thing, because why wouldn't you want to save 20%? Right?
Indeed.
So there you go. Shop.freetalklive.com. Let's go to your phone calls and thoughts. First up, we've got Paul. He's in Maryland. You're on Free Talk Live. Hey, Paul.
Hey, how you doing, guys?
Welcome, sir.
Let me turn the radio off.
That's always a good idea when you're calling.
Yeah,
talk
do that,
radio.
Please.
You always want to listen on hold.
Can you hear me now?
Yes, we have you. Go ahead with your thoughts, sir.
Okay, great. So I was. This is your EPA story. I'm not sure how much the government spends on the EPA as far as its total budget. Do you guys know that?
Probably a boatload of money. I have no idea.
I would say it's probably about maybe 1% or 1%, maybe a half a percent, maybe.
I'd of say the government's entire budget, you mean? Okay.
Yeah, right. I mean, the Pentagon takes half of it right there.
And from discretionary, there's actually, if you start including things like Social Security and Medicare, but...
How about the interest payments on the debt as well? Isn't there a big chunk that goes to that?
As I understand that, that's essentially what the interest payment on the debt is basically what the revenue of income taxes is,
right.
goes to.
All right, Paul, go ahead.
Okay. Well, I want to say that the EPA story is, you know, is what you hear about government, like you guys are saying. The government's doing that all the time.
Wasting money. For those just tuning in, it was $92 million on furniture over the last decade.
And I'd be willing to bet that the EPA is by no means the only organization. I'd say the Pentagon is probably the worst as far as waste goes.
Oh, yeah.
We can look at their F-35 program and see just what a catastrophe that is. It was recently beaten by the F-16, which I think was put in service in the late 70s or maybe early 80s.
What did that cost? What did that program cost?
I've got to have to look that up. I mean, you're catching me flat-footed here, but it was incredible. It's, you know, hundreds of billions.
I'm glad you're going in that direction, because if you're talking about government spending, that's where it's at. And I really want to appeal to you. I want to appeal to you, Mark, as a Quaker, you know, who probably believes in maybe less war, anti-violence,
less.
Anti-state control.
What and what state control?
Anti.
Anti-state control.
Yep, okay.
Less control by the state.
Yeah.
Yeah?
Well, yeah.
You're appealing to him about what, though? I mean, what do you?
Well, I'm appealing to you that the Pentagon money that we spend, not only is it really wasted tax money. Besides the $8.2 trillion, you guys should look that up.
Dude, you know, we don't have to look up the numbers. We're on your side. I'd like to end the Pentagon, okay? I'd like to end the government's military.
As far as I'm concerned, the protection of the United States can probably be handled in a decentralized fashion, perhaps by people that own guns, maybe a militia situation. But if you're not looking to control the planet, you don't need a military like we have.
Does that help clarify?
Excellent. What I see is as the military is being another layer of control in our government. Basically, it's corporations. The military-industrial complex, as President Eisenhower called it,
a Republican,
is another layer of control over us. We're controlled by the state, and now the state is controlled essentially by these corporations who are telling the government what to spend their money on. Our money on. I'm sorry.
Yeah. Well, I mean,
it's not yours anymore.
It's not yours anymore. Once you give it to them, it becomes theirs.
Hey, thanks, Paul, for the thoughts tonight. I appreciate hearing from you. And I get what you're saying, right? Like, you know, one agency is a lot bigger than the other, but the waste is across the board. It doesn't matter what government agency you're talking about. They're all wasteful because they have no incentive to do anything but waste.
I think what Paul's used to hearing on the radio is a bunch of people that complain about government spending until somebody arms a bureaucrat, at which point that bureaucrat grows wings and becomes an angel. Right? And it's not just guns, hoses, too. So I'm a fireman.
Anything that shoots.
Yeah. I'm a fireman, and everybody thinks that, you know, firemen are a bunch of angels, too. By no means. These are people that work for the government. They provide a service, and that service could, in my opinion, likely be served, provided more efficiently through the free market. However, we don't have that today. So today, I'm going to work with my local government to pull people out of burning cars and the variety of things we do.
I'm sure if I looked, I'd be able to find some sort of recent military waste spending story, too. It's just the EPA story happened to come across my desk.
We did the Pentagon earlier this week on Thursday. So, I mean, I did a story on the Pentagon spending, the Pentagon bureaucrats using their credit cards, their government credit cards.
See, I wasn't even here on Thursday night.
Credit cards to get strippers and gamble.
There you go.
We also talked about the Secret Service doing prostitutes down in Colombia, the DEA with prostitutes
that were being
paid for by the cartels. What's wrong with that? That's not a conflict of interest at all.
Remember, Joe Arpaio, by the way, the world's toughest sheriff or America's toughest sheriff, whatever. I think he's trademarked that, by the way, that tagline. Yeah. Anyway, Joe Arpaio, he made his sort of name for himself as the DEA administrator in Mexico City.
Okay.
So here you are with a story about the DEA. It was in Mexico, right, with the prostitutes?
I think it was in Colombia.
Colombia? Okay, whatever. Okay. So the DEA cavorting with cartel-provided prostitutes in Central or South America, and then you've got Joe Arpaio acting like he's all Mr. Holy Roller, he's so innocent, great cop kind of guy. He was in charge of the DEA. And you don't think that kind of shenanigans was going on with Joe Arpaio in charge. You just don't know anything about how this stuff works. So that should be a window into the world of corruption that will likely be running rampant throughout the DEA. Don't think for a moment, it's just a few bad apples, just a few bad officers. This was probably going to the highest levels of the DEA down there.
Well, I've come to the conclusion after doing Free Talk Live for 12 years that my assumption is going to be that the government needs to prove its innocence when an accusation's made, not the other way around.
That's how they treat you.
Ultimately, that if somebody made some wild accusation, I'm going to make them, prove it. But if it comes to spending, if it comes to corruption, there's things that I'm just going to believe out of hand. And do I believe the government bureaucrats are going to cavort with prostitutes, spend inordinate amounts of money on their credit cards, and spend too much on their office stuff, and go to have huge parties with all kinds of alcohol flowing, and maybe some other drugs. And
it wasn't long.
I've just seen it happen too many times, people.
It wasn't even more than a year or two ago. We heard about the Secret Service having sex with prostitutes or whatever.
I'm not some kind of anti-government fool here. I came to this, your standard issue citizen. I've just seen over time, these stories. I've come to the conclusion as an average individual inundated with these stories that this is what government bureaucracies do. And frankly, you can look at history. It doesn't take much of a historical eye to say, Turns out, the less accountable an organization is, the more likely they are to be corrupt.
So I thought I'd seen it all, Mark, when it comes to these police stories and the drug war, for instance. You've seen, I'm sure, a million times the pictures of the cops standing next to their take, right? The, we busted the biggest marijuana stash that we've ever seen in the history.
A giant pile of money, but you don't know how much they've got in their pockets.
Yeah, and you know, they usually pile up the pot, too, right? Like, oh, we're so bad, and look what we've done here. We've taken down the entire cartel with this bust. Beckley, West Virginia, Associated Press reporting. This is real. This is really from WVVA.com. West Virginia Natural Resources Police say they have made 11 arrests and seized 190 pounds of dry ginseng.
Oh, boy. Ginseng, huh?
That was illegally harvested. The West Virginia Department of Natural Resources estimates the market value of the native herb at $180,000. The department said Wednesday the arrest followed a year-long investigation in southern West Virginia. Besides the ginseng, they said they also seized stolen guns, illegal drugs, and $30,000 in cash. And when they say the illegal drugs, it probably was the guys who were harvesting the ginseng had a bag of marijuana on them or something like that, and a gun. West Virginia has a ginseng digging season that begins between September 1st and runs through November 30th. The department says the seized ginseng was harvested before the digging season began.
Well, you can't do that.
Ginseng long has been coveted in many Asian cultures because the plant's gnarly, multi-pronged root is believed to have medicinal properties. Natural resources officials say demand has spurred the illegal harvesting.
Well, so, wouldn't want demand.
Here you have pictures of cops standing in front of hundreds of pounds of ginseng. And, you know, they got their arms crossed, acting like they've done something to take down the criminals because they harvested their crop too early. I mean, this is ridiculous. We'll see you tomorrow night online in the meantime at freetalklive.com.
Delighted Health Insurance executives gather in an outdoor coliseum to watch a patient battle cancer, and a self-conscious flasher is fully clothed under his trench coat. This is the Onion Week in Review. While stressing that they would absolutely never consider doing anything of the sort, German leaders quietly admitted this week that they were pretty sure they could carry out another Holocaust if they ever truly wanted to. Quickly noting that the Holocaust was an atrocity that should never be repeated, no matter how easy it would be to do so, almost all members of the German parliament discreetly conceded that with their country's dominance of Eurozone GDP, pulling off the unthinkable genocide would not be the least bit difficult.
I'm just saying, hypothetically, that we very easily could do it. I mean, we definitely have the infrastructure, and the concentration camps are still standing.
In other news, a so-called Christian has an erection. A new study finds more children are growing up in single-parent households, and a real-life Nancy Drew traces the source of her HPV.
This is the Onion News Network.
If you have a business, you know that IT can be frustrating, but it doesn't have to be. IT can serve your needs reliably, predictably, and on time. Rootwork Infotech helps businesses achieve always-on reliability. Their nerds know business and can meet your needs. To prove it, they'll give you 30 minutes on the phone with a senior consultant for free to answer any of your IT questions. Just go to rootwork.it/FTL to get your free call. That's rootwork.it/FTL.
Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category, and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com, and Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com.
The live edition of Off the Air Live is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network, LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Saturday, September 26th, 2015. Silver is trading at $15.12 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,146 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $237. Antiwar.com reports, speaking Thursday to the Senate Intelligence Committee, NSA Chief Admiral Michael Rogers claimed that a potential government shutdown was a threat to national security on the grounds that the NSA might lose employees to the private sector if that happens. Rogers claims that NSA employees are so great that they could easily get much better jobs outside of the NSA, and that many are likely to do so if they believe the shutdown is going to threaten their pay, meaning the agency could lose significant numbers of workers. At the core, Rogers' complaint largely echoes some of the government agency chiefs who are opposed to the shutdown because they don't want to see their agency's funding threatened, or worse yet, see them shut down for a period of time long enough that the public realizes that what they're doing isn't really missed when it's gone. That's the real threat to the NSA, in particular with so much of their activity done entirely in secret, and the public only having the government's word for it that what the NSA is doing is actually important. The question could quickly be brought to the fore with a shutdown, and particularly with all the objectionable things the NSA is known to do, their value is already a subject of debate.
For over 35 years, Roberts & Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co.
UPI reports Texas correction officials on Friday admitted that they have supplied doses of a lethal drug to the state of Virginia for an execution there, but refused to disclose how they obtained the chemical. Officials said three vials of the drug pentobarbital were given to the Virginia Department of Corrections. Pentobarbital is a barbiturate often used in lethal injections that can cause death in high doses. On Friday, the Texas Department of Criminal Justice acknowledged that it shared the drug with Virginia, but refused to disclose where they had obtained the pentobarbital. Virginia is scheduled to execute an inmate next week, its first in 2 years. The Texas Department of Criminal Justice said state law prohibits the agency from disclosing the identity of the supplier of lethal injection drugs. Friday's disclosure came a day after attorneys for Oklahoma death row inmate Richard Glossop filed court papers claiming the Texas government is now manufacturing its own lethal injection drugs and it is sharing them with Virginia. Glossop is scheduled to be executed on September 30th, barring a last-minute reprieve. Oklahoma will use the drug midazolam to aid in his execution, but Glossop has requested pentobarbital, which is considered to be more reliable in executions since it appears that Texas is able to supply the drug. You can support FPP Radio by joining the Fans program. Fans are friends, allies, and numerary supporters. Fans help FPP afford to produce more original content. You can join the Fans program for as little as $3 per month or any amount of Bitcoin per month, thanks to the recurring payment options provided by Coinbase. To learn more or to join the Fans program, visit fans.fppradio.com. That's fans.fppradio.com. Reuters reports House Speaker John Boehner will leave Congress at the end of October after struggling with repeated rebellions by conservatives during a tumultuous 5-year reign as the chamber's top Republican. The 65-year-old congressman from Ohio stunned Republican House members at a meeting on Friday morning with the announcement that he would resign his seat.